Live from the Tucson Arena, this is University of Arizona Hockey. It's time to drop the puck with Timothy Gasson, the voice of the Wildcats. So let's head to the action with Arizona Wildcats Hockey.
Welcome to the Tucson Arena, where the number 7 Arizona Wildcats will take on the number 10 Sun Devils of Arizona State. Hi, everybody. I'm Timothy Gasson. I'll be bringing you the action tonight, along with my broadcast partner, Will Harmon. And Will, last night it was a whale of a college hockey game. Arizona came out as 6-4 winners. Either team could have won that game. I expect the same kind of high-flying action tonight. Last night we were wondering, would Arizona's firepower show up? It sure did in the third period.
Yeah, absolutely. It's 6 goals, 10 total goals combined with both teams. That game had everything you want and expect out of a rivalry. There was fighting, tons of goals, a lot of testy moments, a really great crowd atmosphere as well. I really hope that we see that again tonight. As far as Arizona goes, you know, they're down 4-3 in that third period, and they were able to show some resiliency and be able to come back, keep composed, and be able to pull out that win yesterday too. So, you know, I'm excited to see how things from yesterday bleed into today. Hopefully we get a little bit more goals and maybe some fights too.
Well, I think it's going to be nasty like it got last night. Hotly contested game. It really did get nasty. There were a number of scrums going on between the two teams. There's nothing like this rivalry between Arizona and Arizona State, especially in hockey. It goes back decades, and there's just nothing quite like it. Well, we talked to a brand new Wildcat about what it's like playing ASU, and if he understands what this rivalry is all about yet. So let's go to Jackson Peters and his guest to talk about this rivalry with Arizona State.
Hi, I'm Jackson Peters, and I'm joined here by University of Arizona Wildcat hockey defenseman Cameron Timor. Now, Cameron, your fourth time tonight playing Arizona State University. Can you tell me a little bit how you're starting to adjust, and, you know, do you really start to get a sense of what this rivalry is and what it means to the fans and supporters of U of A hockey?
Definitely. The fans are everything. The atmosphere was really good last night, so that kind of makes it intense. Plus, it's, you know, when you're in state, it's always nice because guys are battling and things like that nature, the fights. So, yeah, I'm starting to get a clue what it's all about.
Yeah, and like you said, you're starting to get a clue of what it's all about. Can you tell me a little bit about your adjustment from the North American Hockey League to ACHA Division I and how you've handled that? And, you know, what are some of the, you know, comparisons you see between the two leagues?
Yeah, the guys here are bigger and more mature, obviously, older guys. So it's definitely a challenge. So, yeah, every night you just got to keep working and battle. So it's good.
Well, we've been speaking with Cameron Timor. We'll send it back to the booth with Tim Gasson.
Thank you, Jackson. So the Arizona Wildcats enter tonight's contest 9-1-1 on the season, ranked number 7 in that initial computer ranking. Arizona State is 8-4-1, a big number 10 in the first ACHA computer rankings. You know, it's early in this season, but it's not too early to talk about the Cactus Cup. Arizona already has the lead in the season series against Arizona State. If they win here tonight, they've got a big jump up on the Cactus Cup standings against ASU, because the rest of the games against ASU are right here in Tucson.
Yeah, no, this is going to be huge. I mean, for a team like ASU, we've talked about their improvement and they're being ranked number 10. And so for Arizona to be able to sweep a home series and really take a stronghold on the Cactus Cup, I think that'd really show that, you know, Arizona's like, hey, you know, we're still really good too. And for ASU, they're in that game yesterday. You know, they easily could have probably won that game as well. And so for today, they're coming into this one thinking we can split this series, we can win today. So obviously with Cactus Cup implications, that's always huge, one of the season goals of the year. So I'm excited Arizona to come back out and be really hungry again today.
Well, we talked about it a lot last night, how improved Arizona State is this season. Last year, Arizona swept the entire 8-game series against ASU. Well, ASU already has a tie against Arizona this year. That's the ACHA tie, as we explained in the WCHL League rankings. That comes up as a shootout loss for Arizona. But for the Cactus Cup, Arizona has 2 wins and a tie, but they are much improved, and they've had some real firepower with Clayton Lackey, number 19 in black for ASU. We'll talk to him at the end of the first period. But Lackey was all over the ice last night. If Arizona does not keep track of him, he's going to light the lamp a couple times.
No, he's got a ton of skill, a ton of speed, as we saw. He can stop on a dime. He's got really great stick skills as well. Elliot Plourde as well, them playing together is definitely a bonus for them as well. If Arizona really wants to win this game, they're going to need to knock Lackey off the puck a little bit and make sure he doesn't get in the spaces that he likes to expose.
Now, we had a lot of goals scored last night, but we had really good goaltending. It talks to how skilled offensively these two teams are. I expect Anthony Shiro for Arizona and Bronson Moore for ASU to start again tonight. Now, each one of the goalies, they did play well. They each let in one of those little dribblers kind of goals. I get an idea in the competitive atmosphere tonight that's going to be ratcheted up. Neither goaltender can afford to give up one of those kinds of goals tonight.
No, definitely. And that's one of those things, too, playing, you know, 24 hours later. I mean, for as far as your body and stamina goes, those are kind of the type of plays that kind of are typical to happen later on in a series, like 24 hours later, like I was saying. I mean, a lot of those big hits that we saw yesterday, obviously those probably hurt in the moment. But once your adrenaline goes down and then you're feeling it the next day, I'm interested to see how the skating goes for both of these squads.
Well, you talk about the 24-hour turnaround. One of the things I love about these college hockey two-game series, it's a chance for instant redemption. Whoever lost that first game, hey, they don't have to wait long. Just less than 24 hours later, they're back on the ice against the rival. ASU is going to be a highly motivated hockey team here tonight. They had the lead on the road against number 7 Arizona last night. We'll see how they do tonight. Okay, so let's send it down to ice level. We'll have the starting lineups and then the national anthem. Then we'll drop the puck between number 7 Arizona and number 10 Arizona State. You are watching University of Arizona Wildcats Hockey.
The battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, knocking out bodies, standing on top like a champion. Keep your silver, give me that gold. You'll remember when I say it. We're unstoppable. Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us.
And here come the Wildcats coming from the locker room. We're waiting for ASU to take the ice, and then we can have the starting lineups and the national anthem. ASU getting some last-second talk in the locker room before this one. Timothy Gasson here along with Will Harmon. And here we go with the starting lineups for tonight's contest between Arizona and Arizona State.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and hockey fans everywhere. Welcome to the Tucson Convention Center Arena, the home of your University of Arizona Wildcats. Tonight, your Wildcats take on the Sun Devils from the Arizona State University. Here's the starting lineup for the visiting Sun Devils. Starting at left wing, number 9, Adam Havner. At right wing, number 20, Tim Hoffenkamp. At the center position for the Devils, number 10, Andrew Husted. At left defense, number 27, Connor Kruk. At right defense, number 18, Ryan Lampier. And in the nets tonight for the visiting Sun Devils, number 1, Bronson Moore. The head coach is Tate Green. And ladies and gentlemen, here's the starting lineup for your Arizona Wildcats. Starting at left wing for your Cats, number 15, Anthony Cusinelli. At right wing, number 12, Chris Westland. at the center position for your Cats, number 11, Bailey Marshall. At left defense, number 17, Ben Jones. At right defense, number 13, Matthew Hall. And in the nets tonight for your Wildcats, number 35, Nolan Bivolsek. Head coach of your Wildcats is Chad Berman. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please direct your attention to the promotion stage, which is up above the scoreboard, as University of Arizona hockey organist Mike Davis performs tonight's national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen,
and we're ready to drop the puck between number 7 Arizona and number 10 Arizona State. I'm Timothy Gaston along with Will Harmon, and we have a little bit of a surprise here in goal for the Arizona Wildcats. Will, Nolan Bivolsek, the steady backup to Anthony Shiro, gets the nod here tonight. You know, Nolan has played so well this season. He'd be the starting goaltender for just about every ACHA team. Such a good backup, and he's getting rewarded with the start here against Arizona State. Bronson Moore, the number one goaltender for Arizona State, is back in goal for the Sun Devils. I'm not surprised there. So this is not a comment on Anthony Shiro's performance, for sure. They're just giving a more quality time on a Saturday night against the rival. Here to Nolan Bivolsek.
Yeah, that's what, you know, we've seen the coaching staff kind of do this. They like to interchange these two goalies throughout the season, you know, kind of split them one and one almost. And, you know, Bivs is a very quality goaltender as well. And you know, it's definitely, like you said, not a knock on Turo at all.
And the puck is down, and we are underway between Arizona and Arizona State. Of course, the Wildcats big 6-4 winners last night in the comeback bid here on home ice. Another good crowd on a Saturday night, a homecoming day for football here at the University of Arizona. So a lot of returning Wildcats in Tucson today. And there's nothing that screams University of Arizona like the rivalry with Arizona State. Arizona wearing their retro 1990s New York Rangers styled Arizona Whites with that beautiful Saguaro cactus. And ASU is in their dark jerseys. You know, it's kind of hard to determine if those are really dark brown or if they're black jerseys, but they're very dark jerseys with their gold trim. And the Sun Devil on front. So we're in the first minute of play. Puck comes in on Morton, bounces back out to center ice. You wouldn't think there'd be a feeling out period in this game, Will, because last night the two teams got to know each other very intimately by the end of the game. You would think that the fireworks would start pretty early here.
Yeah, definitely. There's a lot of bad blood still bleeding over from yesterday, so I'm interested to see who's going to be the person that throws the first punch here.
Well, and, you know, who keeps their head.
Exactly.
We saw last night because, you know, one of the linesmen was injured. We only had a referee and one linesman. There was a lot of stuff happening away from the puck, and not a lot of it could be caught because there was only one referee and one linesman. And a lot of retaliations are caught in those kinds of situations. Which team is smart enough not to retaliate and get caught for that kind of penalty? Cats just throw the puck into the zone. Justin Plumeth digs for it there, but the Cats go for a partial change.
Wildcats not able to keep it in, regroup at center ice, and just throw it high off the glass right at the blue line. I think that's going to be called a hand pass. So we'll have a whistle and a faceoff inside the Arizona State Zone. Just underway here. Not even 2 minutes into this game. We're scoreless. Now, in rivalry games like this, all those obvious things have to happen, of course. You got to stay out of the box, which is easier for us to say about the Arizona Wildcats than it is to actually do. You have to, you know, keep away from those silly penalties. You've got to take advantage of your power play opportunities, and that's what Coach Tate Green from ASU thought was really the difference in last night's game. Wasn't it?
Yeah, he talked about how the Arizona Wildcats had a little bit more experience as a team that's kind of used to these type of games. And you mentioned that there are a lot of new, fresh faces on this ASU team, and he said they're still trying to kind of work around that. And as far as like picking up penalties, and he did mention that Arizona, he thought the Wildcats did a better job taking advantage of those power play situations.
Well, we're skating 5-on-5 here now. We'll see how long that lasts, though. There was a good parade to the penalty box last night. But, you know, like last night's game, Will, this one is starting kind of sleepy and slow. Not a lot of physical intensity so far. Both teams really with their mind on playing hockey and staying away from the other stuff.
Yeah, the other thing, too, I want to mention on, like, stamina and stuff is, you know, when there's all those penalties and guys who are kind of, you have those 2-10 minutes, you have a lot of guys picking up a lot of extra shifts. And so you're maybe getting a little bit more ice time than you're used to, a lot of penalty killing, a lot of power plays. And so that also adds into the stamina as well.
Cats come away with the puck. That's the Dawson Marshall trying to send it down low, but it's intercepted. Pinballs into the corner where Ben Jones digs for it there. Comes up the near side boards. ASU's able to keep it in, send it to the far side. Cats pick it up, and now here's Bailey Marshall over the line. And a shot and a save by Bronson Moore. Some good speed there by Bailey Marshall coming over the line. And here's some good news. I see Anthony Cusinelli out on the ice, the incredibly talented offensive player and captain of the Wildcats. He left last night's game, but is good to go here tonight. And that's really good news for the Arizona Wildcats.
Definitely. The captain and the clear leader of the team, and for him to be back out here tonight is a great sign.
Bailey Marshall with some speed. He throws the puck in front, but there was no one there. Cats got to be careful about blindly throwing the puck out in front because it comes into a rush back the other way. That's just what ASU does as Andrew Husted throws the puck up high and into the near side corner. Neither goaltender really tested yet in this one. We're 4.5 minutes into the first period. Scoreless. Marshall picks up the puck to Westland, throws it back down low. Romani Rowe picks up the puck, sends it back to his line mate, Timor. And we talked to Cameron Timor in the pregame show. Boy, he had a big goal last night. He has made a big impact as a freshman. And, of course, we kind of chuckle when we call Cameron Timor a freshman, a 21-year-old freshman who played a lot of juniors. He's a mature young man. The puck dribbles in on Bronson Moore, and he makes the save. There's a huge difference. I think 18-year-olds don't realize how different a human being they're going to be when they're 21 years old. There's physically, mentally, emotionally, there's a huge difference between an 18-year-old freshman and a 21-year-old freshman.
Definitely. He's not just a brand new, you know, 18-year-old freshman coming out onto the team. He's had a lot of experience, and he has a lot of energy and size. And one of the things I like about him is his offensive play as well. He's very calm on the puck and does a really good job not really turning over the puck either. And then obviously defensively, he's a very strong defenseman as well. Wildcats doing a little bit better here as well off the top, you know, with active sticks and checks compared to what they were doing yesterday off the top. They were just kind of puck watching a little bit, and it's good to see their sticks active today.
Cats break up ice and get a good shot on goal on Bronson Moore, but he's there and makes the save. We remain scoreless just about 5.5 minutes into this one. You know, as the game went on last night, Arizona used their speed better. Arizona State showed from the get-go that they have some skill and some speed, especially on the outside. The Devils win the face-off there, but Matthew Hull for Arizona tried to flip the puck up and down the ice, but instead it goes out of play. I think that could have been called a delay of game. I'm wondering why it wasn't called a delay of game.
I was thinking the same thing.
Matthew Hull for Arizona tried to kind of cup that puck down low, but it went out of play. Maybe the referee didn't see how it went out of play, but I think that could have been a two-minute delay of game, I think, against Arizona. But we play on 5-on-5, and I'm not complaining about the fact that we're playing 5-on-5 because we had a lot of odd man situations in the game last night. Justin Plumhoff comes up the wing, just throws it on goal, looks for a rebound. Hull's able to keep it in briefly, but Jet Larson comes away with the puck now into the Arizona zone, takes a spill, trying to draw a penalty, and our referee, Tom Bibbs, just nods his head no, and we continue. There's a missed pass that goes all the way down the ice, and they do call an icing, so we'll have the puck come back into the Arizona zone. 13:20 to go in the first period. We're scoreless, and I wouldn't say that both teams are tentative here, but somehow neither one seems to have the kind of continuity that we saw in yesterday's game.
Yeah, the mood seems a little bit different only 24 hours later. I mean, I think we have we had a lot of big hits right off the bat yesterday, and I think today they're just both kind of playing it, kind of hanging in the pocket a little bit here. And
what's interesting is both benches are standing up as if this is like the last couple minutes of a game. I think both teams are trying to find that spark. They're trying to find that energy to get going. They realize neither team has established themselves so far in this game, and they're looking to make something happen as Arizona ices the puck again, and we'll have another faceoff in the Arizona zone. And as I mentioned last night, we'll see, you got to be careful about icing the puck in that third period, and you're going to be pretty tired out there, but we're just 7 minutes into this first period, and Arizona's iced the puck a number of times. Cats come away with the puck, come up 2-on-2. It's Josh Larson with the puck behind the net. He's sandwiched there, but Trey Decker tries to come away with it. Does get up to Manny Rowe at the point. Back to Josh Larson. He's hit from behind into the boards. Now, yesterday, that was called a penalty. That one perhaps did not rise to the level of a penalty. Josh Larson kind of thrown to his knees and able to stop himself from going into the boards. So there's a good non-call. As play continues on, Arizona State trying to feather that puck through the slot, but it comes out to center ice. Cats are 2-on-3 here. Phil Artizone makes a hit as Ethan Stalhuth digs for a puck. Dawson Marshall comes away with it, brother of Bailey Marshall. Sends it back to the point, good pass. Shot comes in and goal, just dribbles wide. That was a good deflection. The puck pinballs through the crease again and now out to center ice, and ASU looks to counterpunch. That's Andrew Husted with a nice save by Nolan Bivalsik. The Cats get it back to center ice. Both goaltenders have looked solid here, but there really haven't been any A1 kind of scoring opportunities yet, Will.
Yeah, it's a completely different feeling, I think, from yesterday where, you know, we have 10 combined goals. I mean, I think maybe today we hope, I mean, maybe it's just a smaller scoring game today.
Well, we're scoreless so far. almost halfway through this first period. Not a lot of offensive continuity, but here comes Arizona carrying the puck to center ice. And over the blue line, it's Bailey Marshall. So dangerous with the puck. He isn't able to find a Wildcat, and we do have a whistle, and we're going to have our first penalty of the game. And this is going to be a power play for Arizona. Elliot Plourd goes to the box for 2 minutes, and Arizona will have a power play. Their first power play opportunity of the night. You know, we talked about the turnaround from being down by a goal to winning by a couple was helped.
Plourd, 2 minutes for tripping. Time of that penalty, 8 minutes, 50 seconds in the first period. And gives your Wildcats a Hogan Transportation power play.
And those power plays, what gave Arizona the opportunity to get back in that game. Arizona is able to keep the puck in the zone. Plumuff with the puck, sends it down low. Chris Westland. Over to the circle, over to Westland. He just redirects that on the net. If that's at the near side post, that's a goal. But instead, it bounced off of Moore. That was a really good idea. Quick movement of the puck and just getting that puck on goal.
Yeah, that was probably the first big chance of the game. And, I mean, you'd like to see the Wildcats maybe take advantage of this power play situation when there hasn't really been all that many goal-scoring chances yet.
There's Moore tries to get that puck up. And he does get it out to center ice. That was a... It turned out to be a good play, but he turns it right back to Timothy Hoffenkamp, turn it right back to Jesse Lowell. He comes into the dot. They let him continue to step in, so he took a shot that went wide, came back to Lowell, sent down low, misses Justin Plumhoff there. But Lowell comes away with Ben Jones, rather, comes away with it to the circle. Oh, and there was a missed pass over to Justin Plumhoff, and it comes out to center ice. The Cats just a little out of sync on that sequence. But still 40 seconds to go on the power play as a Sun Devil wipes out behind the Arizona net. Puck goes over the stick of Bailey Marshall, and we're going to have a whistle and an ice on the power play, I think. That's a big no-no. You got a man advantage. The last thing you want is to ice the puck. We're more than halfway home here in the first period. 9:43 to go in the period. Number 7, Arizona. Number 10, Arizona State. We are scoreless. Anthony Cusinelli comes away with the puck, and he's skating well there, and that's a really good sign. Anthony Cusinelli is such an important part of this team, and there's Bailey Marshall back to the far side, back to Bailey Marshall. Oh, if that puck had settled down, he would have taken a shot there. He had to settle that puck down. Comes and doesn't get through, and it's going to dribble out to center ice. The last 10 seconds of the power play for Arizona. Looks like it's going to be killed off. 2-1, and that's it. So we remain scoreless, 9:05 to go in the first period. In a much more closely checking game than last night, where there were times where there was a lot of open ice.
Yeah, we already are 10 minutes into this game, and I feel like both teams really haven't really been connecting on passes. Everything seems a little bit out of sync for both teams here.
Now, both teams did play, 24 hours ago last night, and that was a tiring game. But I don't think it's a problem with energy level. Let's play back on. The puck goes all the way down, and they're calling this an ice. I'm surprised that they didn't wave that one off, but it's an icing. We'll come back for another faceoff in the Arizona zone. If there's one thing Arizona has done a lot of in this period, it's they've iced the puck.
Yeah. So keeping with the tired legs out there as well. Maybe ASU takes advantage in this faceoff here in their zone.
Cats win the faceoff and pound it up the near side, and it does come to center ice. Puck goes down low, and there's Dawson Marshall who takes a shot. Bronson Moore doesn't know where the puck is. That puck has to be inside the net. That has to be in the net. No sign yet. No goal. He somehow made a save there. How did that puck not go in the net, Will?
That's one of those plays that we were talking about, one of those plays where the puck's bouncing around, and I think Bronson Moore just kind of did everything he could to keep it out of there.
So we'll have a faceoff to the left of Bronson Moore. Won by the Sun Devils. Kenneth Miller sends it around and now out to center ice. Big hit there on Timothy Hoffenkamp at the ASU blue line, but the Hoffenkamp has the puck. He takes another hit, and there's a big shot that comes right back to a Sun Devil. But now it comes back out to center ice. That's probably the best opportunity for Arizona State. So there's a shot that Moore thought he had, but it gave up a rebound and it dribbled forward. Luckily for him, one of his teammates was there to collect the puck. So a couple opportunities here suddenly in the second half of this first period for both teams, but we remain scoreless. There's Andrew Husted, skated really well last night for Arizona State, sending the puck down low. Arizona comes away with it and chips it to center ice. Arizona State has really added a couple key elements to this squad from last year's squad that was close in a lot of games to Arizona, but just couldn't get over the hump. So there's a nice big wind up from Trey Decker, comes in on Moore, and he makes the sure save. And we remain scoreless. Now, stick around, Wildcat fans, between the first and second period. We'll show you highlights and interviews and everything to do with Arizona Wildcat hockey. And then we'll also talk to Clayton Lackey, number 19, the sniper for the Arizona State University Sun Devils. That's between the first and second period here on University of Arizona Wildcat hockey. Puck comes back to Matthew Hull. He sends it down low. It doesn't get through. And we have a whistle. I think we may have had a hand pass here. You know, maybe it is an energy. It is an energy issue, Will. I don't see a lot of jump in either of these teams. Is it a big hit? Is it something, you know, to do with the rivalry that's going to get these guys going? What do you think's going on?
I don't know. I think it's going to take a couple big hits here. I mean, obviously, we saw a power play there for Arizona a couple minutes ago. But, you know, just all around, it feels something just feels kind of off. And I think you kind of look at maybe some of the leaders of Arizona, Manny Rowe or Cusinelli, to kind of jumpstart things for the Wildcats. Then on the other side, if you're Clayton Lackey, you know, you're looking at taking every chance you can to try and fly through that blue line like we saw yesterday.
Well, you know, the team on the road can take advantage if there's a kind of an energy vacuum here. If they get the first goal, that will change that ratio pretty darn quickly. So it's interesting. We're talking about we're feeling like a low energy feel or something. Both of the benches are on their feet really into this game. I think both of these teams are trying to jockey for a little bit of position and see what's going to work here tonight. I mean, that's the sign of two really good hockey teams. Either one of the teams last night could have won that game. Arizona came away with the victory. And ASU knows they're that close as Bailey Marshall comes in, sends a puck off the blocker of Moore. Boy, that's Bailey Marshall so dangerous coming down the slot here, and he was still able to get the shot off with a couple Sun Devils on him. He's right in the slot again, but he doesn't have the puck on his stick, and here comes ASU back the other way. You know, we haven't called Clayton Lackey's name a lot so far in this first period. Is Arizona doing a better job of keeping him to the outside, not letting him, you know, just race right up the middle with the puck? I see he's on the ice right now.
I was going to say, this might be a chance to see maybe what he could do. He has been out there a couple times. I think that Wildcats are just doing overall a much, much better job of bumping him off the blue line and just in general trying to keep the puck away from him. You know, he's a dangerous player and the line is dangerous, so I'm excited to see kind of how this line plays now. He is out there. I think it's what's really going to change kind of the tone of this game is whoever scores that first goal. I think both teams are kind of content to just kind of hang back, maybe not try and do too much and make a mistake or do something that's going to negatively impact their team. I think whoever ends up scoring that first goal is really going to end up opening up this game in a positive way. And we did just see Lackey on the puck there. You know, it just takes a little bit longer for him to get things going. The Wildcats are doing a little bit better of a job in the neutral zone whenever he has the puck as well.
Well, we were talking about last night how ASU was able to get so much speed going through the neutral zone. There were times where they were really flying over the blue line with the puck, and that was so dangerous. Here's the puck comes out to the dot to Jesse Lowell. He doesn't have anywhere to go with it, though. Comes down low. There's some dipsy doodle. I think that went off of a post, perhaps. And we have a whistle, and I think the net might be off of one of its moorings. That was Alex Johansson, who made a good move in front of the goaltender. And Elliot Plourd is heading to the box once again, I believe. No, he trails off, and it's actually Brendan Studioso heading to the box. So in that sequence, there was a minor penalty, and I think Arizona's going to go back on the power play. Four to go in the first period.
In Studioso, 2 minutes for charging. Time of that penalty, 15 minutes, 6 seconds in the first period. Give us your Wildcats a Hogan Transportation power play.
So Bailey Marshall took a big shot there, but it was going wide, and Bronson Moore made the save. So we'll have a faceoff in the Arizona zone, 4:43 to go in the first. Big opportunity here for Arizona as Ben Jones gets it down to Bailey Marshall. He looks and sends it right past the far post. That was really a pass. Back to Marshall now in the near side dot. He does the exact same play, and it goes wide again. We'll see if he gets a third crack at it. He might want to put that on goal. Comes up the near side, and Marshall digs for it there. Sends it back to Alex Johansson. Oh, and it just went over the stick of Bailey Marshall. Cats keep it in. Over to Marshall. Can he get it down low? He does. It's going to come back to Marshall. He's looking around. Sends it down low. Into the far post. And it's underneath Moore, I think. But, boy, is that outside of the line again? How did he keep that puck out? Wow, if he did, it is right on the line. Well, there's no goal. So there's a couple that I thought could have been under Moore and in the goal, but he keeps it out. We remain scoreless. A little bit more than a minute left on the power play for the Arizona Wildcats. I think this crowd is waiting for something to happen too, Will.
Yeah, the crowd seems a little disengaged as well. But, you know, I do like what I'm seeing on the power play here. They're getting a lot of guys in front of the net, a lot of different bodies like we just saw there. And, you know, I couldn't really tell from here how close that puck was to going in. But you do like to see that effort of getting a lot of bodies in front of the net.
Well, you pay a price for getting into that kind of position in front of the opposing goaltender, and Arizona is willing to do that. That sends a good sign to your teammates when you're willing to take that kind of punishment. The puck now comes out to center ice. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Matthew Hull with the puck now over the line for the Cats. Sends it down low. Chris Westland digs for it there. Comes out, and the Devils are able to get it all the way down the ice. They're going to go for a partial change as the Cats regroup down to the last 30 seconds of the power play. Still time for Arizona to get into the offensive zone and get a shot. It's Jesse Lowell with the puck. Strong player. Another one of the new cogs in this Arizona machine. As Matthew Hull sends it down low, he was looking for that perfect play right on the doorstep, but it doesn't connect. Down to the last 9 seconds of the power play, Arizona's going to kill off another one. Or Arizona State, rather, is going to kill off another one. And that's it. We're back at even strength. The puck comes in, doesn't get through to Moore. Timur dig for it there, and we have a 3-on-1 going the other way. ASU 3-on-1 coming back. It's right in the slot, and there's a shot. And a big save by Nolan Bivalsik. 3-on-1, and Bivalsik makes a huge save for the Arizona Wildcats. Wow, ASU had a choice of three different shooters there, and Bivalsik comes out and makes an acrobatic save. That's the play so far of the game, Will.
I mean, there's one of those plays that we were talking about. Is that what jumpstarts the thing? I think he's got that with his stick. I think he just kind of threw a stick out there, and it ended up kind of batting that one away. That's a great save from Bivalsik.
ASU right back at it, but the Cats come over with the puck, and they have numbers going the other way. It's a 3-on-2, now a 3-on-3. Artizone has the puck on his stick. He almost sent that home. Oh, you know what? Moore has no idea where that puck was. It was right at the bottom of his pad. But I think what Artizone did there was he drew another power play. He caused an ASU Sun Devil to grab him, or so I thought. Instead, the faceoff is coming back to the Arizona zone. I think perhaps he was saying that Arizona hit the puck with a high stick, perhaps. No penalty. Well, I thought he may have drawn a penalty there with that burst of speed going in on Moore, but instead we had a faceoff in the Arizona end of the ice, and the puck just goes wide of the net. 1:50 go in the first period. Arizona needs to get the puck out. They do get it out to center ice. Comes back to Artizone. Boy, he skated hard last night, too. Dale Artizone. You know, when you call a guy's number and you notice him on the ice, he's doing something good. Puck comes back into the Arizona zone, and Chris Hedgecock, one of the other new Wildcats, picks it up there. Cats regroup. Just kind of flip it to the ASU blue line and go for a change. ASU tries to take advantage and come over the blue line with the puck. That's Zachary Kowalchuk. Cats break it up, though, and are going to move back. They have their own two-on-one, three-on-one. Anthony Cusinelli takes a shot. Big rebound, and the puck just goes wide. A great opportunity for Arizona. And it's great to see Anthony Cusinelli with some speed taking a nice shot last minute of the period. And there's a big rebound off of Bivalsik. That was the opportunity of the game so far, as we have an ASU player who lost a stick.
I mean, things really have opened up here in the last three, four minutes. We highlighted that save from Bivalsik. Bronson Boers kind of came up with a couple really huge saves. You know, sometimes doesn't know where the puck is, but I mean, he's getting his body in the right spot. And maybe we see a goaltender battle tonight.
Well, so far we have had a goaltender battle. We're scoreless here in the first period. Arizona's had a couple power plays, but they weren't able to connect. Here's Jesse Howell with the puck coming up. Takes a shot to the wide side, kicked away by Bronson Moore. Cats come back one on three. Take a poor angle shot, but they make Moore make the save. I think one thing's going to be apparent in 32 seconds, Will, that Arizona is shooting the puck.
Yeah, they're definitely getting...
When we see the shots on goal.
Right. Oh, yeah, definitely. They're getting a lot of shots on net. And like I said, Moore's really had to come up with a couple really huge saves. We talked about the five-minute increments yesterday. I think this last 5 minutes in particular have been really exciting for both teams. And both teams have had, they traded three-on-ones, and they're getting some better chances going here, too.
Yeah, it's interesting. It took a full 15 minutes for this game to kind of open up and the teams to kind of show how they really are. As there's a good tussle there with Manny Rowe at the blue line, the Cats are able to keep the puck in the zone. Now, Manny Rowe is really smart. He backed off of there before he got involved in something that was going to turn into a penalty. So kudos to Manny Rowe. There's the puck pinballs wide. Can the Cats come back the other way? Max Meyer with it. Meyer's taken down. He kind of took a dive. And there's some more jostling. And we were waiting for things to heat up. And there's Manny Rowe heating it up.
Shots on goal in the first period. Arizona with 23. The score after one complete.
So that's it for the first period of play. I think I heard 23 shots on goal for Arizona.
I was going to say, 23 is a lot.
And 9 for Arizona State. I know they had a lot of shots on goal. If they continue at that pace and have 69 shots on goal, some of those are going to go in the net.
Yeah, I mean, I know we had U of A had a lot of shots on that. 23 is a surprisingly high number, especially that discrepancy between 23 and 9. Maybe I'm wrong. I felt like that was a pretty evenly matched, I think, as far as scoring chances go. Going back to that last play there, we were highlighting Clayton Lackey and what he can do on offense. I mean, I know there was maybe 7 seconds left or so. He did really well to get back and back check that and to make sure that they closed out the first period there still tied at 0.
Yeah, I think a little bit of momentum for both teams going into the locker room. I think they're going to come out with a little more fire in their engines here in the second period. Looking at it in the wider context, the road team, the lower-ranked team, the team that lost last night, they got to be just a little bit happier to be even after one period of play. They can rope it over Arizona. The longer the underdog keeps it low scoring or no score at all, the better it is for them. I think ASU has to be pretty happy with that period.
Yeah, that's. I mean, we sound like broken records, but I mean, every single the first period and second period, they went in tied, and again today here it's 0-0. And again, I want that shot discrepancy, 23-9. Like I said, I the feeling was that the scoring chances were about even, both aside from a couple of the power plays and penalty kills there from ASU. Arizona didn't take advantage of those power plays like they were able to yesterday. So we'll be interested to see if that continues or if they can take advantage of some of those penalties.
Well, stick around, Wildcat fans, because right now we're going to have a series of features and everything you want to know about the Wildcats. After that, we'll have an interview with Clayton Lackey, a forward for Arizona State University, right before the start of the second period. At the end of the first period of play, it's number 7 Arizona 0 and number 10 Arizona State 0. You are watching University of Arizona Wildcat Hockey.
I'm Timothy Gasson. They call me the AZ Puckman. I've been following hockey at the University of Arizona for more than 30 years. And this is my Wildcat Hockey Report.
I'm Timothy Gasson, and welcome to another season of the Wildcat Hockey Report. I'm joined by senior defenseman Manny Rowe. And Manny, I've been excited to see you develop as a defenseman in your years here as a Wildcat. Now it's your senior year. Do you have any specific goals for your development as a defenseman your last time around here with the Wildcats?
I think for the senior ride, it's I got to move all my development down, and I got to help progress all the freshmen and the sophomores and kind of make sure they know what they're doing and what they're getting into, and they know what expectations we have going forward.
Now, you remember what it was like to be a freshman making the transition to college hockey. Yeah. So you know what a good senior leadership can do for a hockey team. Is that what you're trying to transmit to this hockey team?
Absolutely. I remember my freshman year, I had Oz and Olson, and I remember specifically things they said to me, and now those are the same things I project to Timor, and I have Jones and Hull, and they know exactly where they need to be.
Now, you have a new defensive partner this year back on the blue line. Is it difficult to adjust to a new partner? Does it come naturally? How long does it take to get used to working with someone new on the blue line?
Yeah, just about a week during practice, just finding out where he likes to go, where I like to go, if he's more physical at the blue line or likes to sag in a little bit. And then also just getting to know him off the ice, too. I like to build that connection, hanging out with him, and then going to the library as well.
Now, Wildcat fans know a lot about Manny Rowe. They know that he has this wonderful red hair. He has alternating great beards or long hair or this wonderful mustache that he has now. But they probably don't know your real first name, Manny, which is?
My whole name is Raymond Mannix Rowe.
Now, Mannix, that's M-A-N-N-I-X, is named after my favorite TV detective from the 1970s, Joe Mannix from the show Mannix. But you have never seen this television show.
No, my dad told me the same story. He said that was his favorite show, and that's my middle name, but I have not gotten around to watch any of it.
Okay, so I'll tell you a little bit about Mannix. Mannix was really intelligent. He was really cool. And the women really liked Mannix. So I can't think of a better first name for you than Mannix.
I mean, if he was a redhead, too, I'd have to say spot on.
So that's all in good fun, Manny. Mannix Rowe. But I'm looking forward to seeing what you do on the ice here in your senior season. Is there one thing that you want to achieve here, other than the obvious, we all want to be champions. There's one thing that you want to achieve here as a Wildcat before you graduate, besides watching an episode of Mannix with me, and I guarantee you I'm going to make that possible for you on one of your road trips. What is it that you want to achieve here?
Back-to-back WCHL, and we want to end in the top 5. That's it's an eye-opener, and some people just thought it was kind of, they didn't think it was real that we got the WCHL, so we want to go back-to-back and really show them with a top-5 finish.
Well, we've been talking with senior defenseman Manny Rowe. Congratulations on this wonderful year last year, Manny, and good luck for this year. And let's continue on now with more of the Wildcat Hockey Report. It's another goal! It's a beautiful tip in by Tyler Griffin.
fifth. That's Ethan Staliuk with the goal. Here's a shot to goal. Arizona takes the lead. And Anthony Cuccinelli with the backhander. He shoots. He scores. Your Arizona Wildcats, champions of the Cactus Cup.
Hi, I'm Jackson Peters, and I'm joined here with the head coach of the University of Arizona Wildcat hockey team, Coach Chad Berman. And Coach, we're standing in front of the Tucson Arena ice, something you guys haven't seen a lot of this far. Can you talk about a little bit, you know, of what you guys have had to do to find ice and how that's affected you, you know, with your preparations for the season?
Yeah, so we've been making some trips to Chandler, Gilbert, Scottsdale, touring the whole area there. So it's been an adventure and a journey, but we're big proponents. The thing we're pushing this year is wherever there's adversity, there's opportunity. And so opportunity in that is we've gotten to know each other a little more on the bus, and it's like we've been on the road early. I think it pulls a team together. So obviously, you know, with an older team that we have, it's nice to have a lot of familiarity with the systems and what we're trying to do structurally. But also you have guys who have been around this culture that understand how to pull the group together.
So something I know that the fan base has definitely seen is the growth of this program over the past few years. This is your sixth year at the helm of this program. Can you talk a little bit about, like, what are some of those milestone, you know, moments that really shaped the growth of where this program has come to be today?
Yeah, I can go big and small, and they're all just as impactful. You know, the first time you beat ASU was a turning point. When I took this program over, we had, I think it was like a 34-game losing streak, and I think we contributed more on top of that the first 2 years. And so when we finally made that happen, it was kind of a turning point of a checkpoint of where we were. You know, obviously winning a conference championship last year in this conference is very difficult to do, so we were really proud of that. As far as little things, you know, this may – the turning point last year we were on a bus in Colorado. We do a lot of meetings on the road in the hotel rooms, things to get to know you. And it's like they say, once you know you've built your culture when they're teaching you. I go to the back of the bus and our group's doing a spelling bee with the rookies. So it was one of the most entertaining bus rides I've had, but it was a sign to me that guys were taking ownership of the group, the culture, how things would blend together. And that really was a turning point, I thought, for us that probably goes unnoticed.
And luckily for you, you have a lot of returning players. Do you think, you know, some of the culture from bus rides like that is going to carry over into this year?
Yeah, I think that stuff's contagious, you know. You got to have, we have 30 guys in our roster, you got to be rowing in the same direction. It is very difficult to get to that point, but we've gotten there. And now it's about sustaining it. So, you know, every day we're making a deposit into the things that makes to keep that consistent and necessary. And you know, hopefully that continues to evolve.
Well, thank you so much, Coach. We've been speaking with head coach of the Arizona Wildcats, Coach Chad Berman. I'm Jackson Peters.
Your hometown hockey team. Your Western Collegiate Hockey League champions. Your Arizona Wildcats. Tickets for Arizona hockey are now on sale. Support your Wildcats as they battle ASU for another Cactus Cup championship and more at the Tucson Arena. Your hockey team, your Arizona Wildcats. Call 791-4101 for tickets now.
It's time for another Arizona Wildcat hockey, this or that.
Crosby or Ovechkin?
Oh. I'd have to go with Ovechkin because he has a pretty nasty one-timer. Yeah.
Mighty Ducks or Blades of Glory?
Blades of Glory. Yeah, Will Ferrell's hilarious.
Blondes or brunettes?
Brunettes. Brunettes. My girlfriend's a brunette, so I kind of have to go with that.
Friends or The Office?
Office, of course. Yeah.
Why?
It's just a classic. I've seen it, like, probably rewatched it 4 or 5 times now. Yeah.
Marvel or DC?
Marvel, no doubt. Yeah.
Why?
Just better movies in general. Better movies, better quality of movies. Yeah.
Morning person or night person?
Definitely a night person, yeah.
Why?
I struggle to get up in the morning sometimes, yeah.
Fair.
That's my alarm clock.
Boxers or commando?
Oh. See, I don't wear boxers, so this is a tough one. So, commando, yeah.
Why?
It's more freeing, more loose.
set there, boys. All right. Backside set. All right, gentlemen, gear down. Good.
You walk into this building on an ASU night, I mean, it feels different. Everybody feels it, from the fans to, you know, the media, down to the coaching staff. Beating these guys, you know, a couple more times, so I don't think that anything could really beat that.
And the Wildcats will secure the Cactus Cup.
There's a shot, Nicole Arizona takes the lead!
That is all Jake Jacobson. He's wheeling and dealing. That's my player of the game, Tim. Easy.
Welcome back to the Tucson Arena after one period of play. We're scoreless between number 7, Arizona, and number 10, Arizona State. Now, we caught up with Arizona State forward Clayton Lackey and talked to him about what it's like to start play with Arizona State and what it's like to play against Arizona, too, because the rivalry is new to him. So let's hear from Clayton Lackey and the Arizona State Sun Devils.
Hi, I'm Jackson Peters, and I'm joined here with Arizona State University Sun Devil Clayton Lackey. Now, Clayton, you've been off to a really hot start with the Sun Devils this year. Can you tell us a little bit about, you know, how that's been for you and, you know, what that adjusts to this level of hockey has been like?
Yeah, I mean, I've been surrounded by a good group of guys so far. Our team's really coming well together. Our top line's been working well together. So I think kind of owe a lot of it to those guys. They've really been helping me put points on the board for us, and we've been working well together. And I think it's been a great opportunity. Coach Tate's let me play my game, which really helps too. So it's really exciting, and I'm just thankful for the opportunity.
And you talked a little bit about how you're starting to work well with these guys. You're coming from the North American Hockey League last year. Can you talk a little bit about how you ended up at ASU and what that transition's been like?
Yeah, so when I finished my youth career in Chicago, Coach Tate first communicated with me when I was in the NA3 at the showcase, and I told him that I was going to try and play all my eligibility in junior and go from there. And then we kind of stayed in touch throughout my years. And then I kind of decided that the D3 route wasn't really what I wanted to do, and I just wanted to stay home, go to school. So I kind of reached out to him, and he said that they'd be happy to have me. So I think that's just kind of how I ended up here, and I'm really glad I made that decision.
Well, we've been speaking with Clayton Lackey. I'll send it back to the booth with Tim Gasson.
Welcome back to the Tucson Arena. Timothy Gasson here along with Will Harmon. We have one period of play in the books between Arizona and Arizona State. And Will, it was kind of a tepid contest until that last 5 minutes. And then both teams got their ire up a little bit. The temperature started to raise a little bit between these two teams. And there were a few more breaks for either team in the last 5 minutes of the first period.
Yeah, and you'd think that probably continues here into the second period. I think they were both just kind of trying to feel each other out and try and see, you know, where both teams were at today. And And as far as Lackey goes, too, you know, we did mention how we weren't necessarily saying his name as much as we were yesterday. You'd expect him to have a couple moments here as well. I think now that the game is going to be opened up a little bit more, I think he's going to end up having a couple chances as well.
Well, another highlight of that first period was a stellar save by Nolan Bavalsik, starting goaltender for Arizona tonight. We were surprised that Anthony Shiro didn't get the nod, the number one goaltender for Arizona. But Nolan Bavalsik is a fine goaltender in his own right. And it was a 3-on-1 for Arizona State in on Bavalsik. Any one of those three skaters could have shot for Arizona State. They sent it to the far side, and a great shot was taken. But somehow, almost like he was cartwheeling, Nolan Bavalsik was able to make a save and remain scoreless.
And that was the moment, really, too, that once that had happened, that's when the game kind of started opening up a little bit more. And I think that really kind of got both teams really pumped up and moving. When you have that great of a scoring chance, kind of robbed there from you by Bavalsik, that makes ASU more hungry, and then that really pumps up the Arizona the team as well, and that really picked things up here in the game.
So the officials are back on the ice. The nets are being put back into place. We're waiting for the two teams to arrive for the second period of play. And I expect things are going to loosen up here a little bit here in this second period of play. To continue on the momentum from that first, the last 5 minutes of that first period. You know, we did not call Clayton Lackey's name as much in that first period as we did last night. It appears that Arizona is doing a little bit better job of picking him up. You know, they want to keep him to the outside. You can't let him have speed coming right down the center of the ice with the puck. That's when he's so dangerous, picking up speed at center ice over the blue line with the puck. If they can keep him to the outside, they think they can keep him from having a lot of impact on this game. And here come the Wildcats back onto the ice. Nice crowd here on Saturday night. Nothing better than hockey Saturday night. And ASU in town to take on the Wildcats. You know, as we mentioned, if Arizona can win this game, they'll have a three-game lead in practical terms in the Cactus Cup. You need to win 5 of the 8 in ACHA wins. According to the ACHA record, they have 2 wins now and a tie against Arizona State. So that would mean literally, you know, they have 2 more games to end the semester. If they would win tonight and those games, they could actually secure the Cactus Cup in this first semester. Now that's looking way ahead. I don't mean to put all those wins in the bank. We're 0-0 to go here with 2 periods of play here tonight. So believe me, I'm not putting those in the bank quite yet. You got to score some goals and you got to win some games. But there's a nice opportunity for Arizona here playing on home ice. And it's great to see Anthony Cusinelli out with the first team here, the first line, and Bailey Marshall. As we mentioned, Anthony Cusinelli left the ice last night, did not return. Well, he's back in the lineup for the Wildcats here tonight. ASU goes for a stretch pass where they are good at that. Instead, they take an icing there. ASU bench really complaining, asking why that was an icing. I think it was an icing. And it was called that. We'll have a faceoff come back into the ASU zone. This was something that for the first half of the game last night, ASU was very effective with their stretch passes. Their breakout of their own defensive zone was very efficient, and they moved from blue line to blue line, or moved the puck from blue line to blue line really quickly. Arizona got better against that as the game went on. Well, you can see Arizona State going back for that stretch pass to try to start the second period. They do enter the zone, get the puck down low. As there's a rebound, comes off of Bavalsik and into the net, and Arizona State takes a 1-0 lead. You could feel something coming there because of how kind of lax Arizona was defensively, kind of watching again as the puck moved around the zone. A rebound by Nolan Bavalsik, and it's in the net, and ASU gets that all-important first goal.
Yep. 40 seconds in here, and they already they took advantage of an opportunity. You know, a lot of bodies in front of the net, and that's one of those things. Maybe you know, we talked about the resiliency there from Arizona, and hopefully they come back and are able to come back from that.
So if Arizona needs a little bit of adversity to wake up, well, they have it now. They're down by a goal early in the second period to Arizona State. We have a faceoff in the ASU zone. We'll wait for the call on that goal.
Arizona State goes by number 10, Andrew Houston. The assist goes to number 9, Adam Havner, and number 20, Tim Hoffenkamp. That's Houston from Havner and Hoffenkamp. Time of the Sun Devil goal, 42 seconds in the second period.
You know, we talk about scoring a goal in the first couple minutes or the last couple minutes of a period. It can change the complexion of a game. Well, Arizona needs to respond now. ASU taking that momentum from the first period and bury their first puck of the evening and take a 1-0 lead. Now, we were talking about consistency last night, Will. We've seen the Wildcats score 9 goals one night and then none the next night. And to be a championship caliber team, you know, you have to be consistent night in and night out. Well, no, we're still early in this game. We're just right at the beginning of the second period. But Arizona potted 6 goals against the same team and the same goaltender last night. They're scoreless so far. And the longer that goes for Arizona State, the more confidence they're going to build up. Play back on as they get the puck right back in the Arizona zone. Arizona gets it to center ice and try to get it pinballs around in front of Moore, but it comes out to center ice and back into the Arizona zone. Alex Johansson picks it up and sends it down low. ASU very patiently brings it into the Arizona zone. There's a big hit there on Brandon Shaw. And Justin Dungy sends it down into the ASU zone. No icing, and play continues on. Just 2.5 minutes into this first period, but Arizona State has broken the ice. They have a 1-0 lead. Now Arizona needs to pick up the pace here and respond. ASU was so good last night for those first two periods of responding to every kind of adversity that Arizona threw at them. Then Arizona was able to prevail in the third period. Well, you're on home ice. It's Saturday night. You have the biggest crowd of the season in the Tucson arena. And you got ASU on the other side of the faceoff dot. I would think that'd be motivation enough, Will.
Yeah, definitely. And we were talking about resiliency as well from ASU and how well they were able to respond to goals that were scored by Arizona. And you really hope that that can happen here for the Wildcats as well. You know, they want to – these next couple shifts are going to be extremely important to make sure that they bring the fight back to them.
Ben Jones goes back for the puck behind his own goaltender. Nolan Bivalsik has played very well, but he gave up one rebound and it ended up in his net. And that's the 1-0 lead for Arizona State. Off the stick of Andrew Houston. And we're back to kind of, we got a 2-on-1 developing here for Arizona. And there's the shot, and did that not go in? It came over to the near side post. I thought it went in. Bronson Moore flips around. The puck did not go in the net.
Absolutely massive save there from Bronson Moore. He was full stretched out there. For that puck to not go in, that's an unbelievable save right there.
That was as big a save as Bivalsik's save.
Definitely.
in the first period, because, you know, that was one of those backdoor plays to the post, and I thought that was just tipped in. That's an amazing save there by Bronson Moore. Now, we talked about how well he played last night. He gave up Well, six goals, or one was an empty netter. And there were six goals, and here comes Arizona State with some speed, 2-on-1. And the pass does not connect there. Very fortunate for Arizona there, is the Arizona State speed went right around the Arizona defense. This easily could be a 2-0 game right now. You know, as we said, this game is starting to loosen up a little bit. I think this is to Arizona State's advantage. As we have a whistle and I believe an ice on the Sun Devils. Yeah, Arizona needs to find its grit and butt right now and push it. Down by a goal. Just 4:20 into the second period. And Arizona State kind of, once again, they did this in the second period last night as well. They're kind of dictating the pace that they want to play at. Arizona needs to respond now. As ASU look at the speed they're getting through center ice, breaking out of their own zone. This is what they were doing effectively for two periods last night. The Cats trying to counter now. Now that can't be a hand pass to yourself.
That's yourself, yeah.
They're calling a hand pass on Arizona. It was an Arizona player who touched the puck with his, they're calling it a hand pass, touched the puck himself to himself. That can't be a hand pass, can it? Well, we're going to have a face-off outside the Arizona State line. Regardless, play continues on. That's a shame because that you know, penalized an Arizona player who was working through a tough check there, was keeping possession of the puck, and then the whistle. Right back into the Arizona end of the ice. ASU trying to dig out, and they come away with the puck. Arizona needs to be gritty here. Hedgecoke with the puck now, intercepting that pass in good position. Cats have to show some defensive grit. Against a fast and talented Arizona State University squad. ASU gives away the puck there, though. There's a shot that goes wide. Nice opportunity in the far side dot. That comes back 2-on-2. Timothy Hoffenkamp just throwing it down low. ASU going for a bit of a change. They had a bunch of guys on the ice there. That should have been too many men on the ice, I think.
I'm with you. I was watching those benches. That was kind of a sloppy change there.
That was a sloppy change, but none of the guys played the puck or were making a play. There were probably 9 or 10 guys on the ice at the same time, it looked like. But play continues on. 14:10 to go in the second period, and boy, you know, there's a big crowd here, but Arizona has to do something to get them involved in this game. They're just kind of sitting back, kind of like Arizona is sitting back right now.
They seem totally fine just kind of hanging back. They're down 1-0, and ASU has taken full control of this game. They're dictating what is going on both offensively and defensively.
Now the crowd trying to get a U of H hand as the puck is loose in front of Morey. Makes a save, but there was a rebound, but no Arizona stick in the neighborhood. Instead, ASU comes back the other way, and you can feel the confidence level of Arizona State rising with every minute that they keep Arizona scoreless here. This is one of those weird games where it's a one-goal lead, but it sure seems like a lot at this point. I think anytime you're held scoreless in a game, it can feel that way. Puck comes loose. ASU comes away with it, but Arizona recovers. Kind of panics there, just send it to center ice. And here comes a Cat in on by himself, but he's called offside. I think he did get in front of the puck there. He didn't quite have it. But Arizona State's going to go to the box.
That's Studioso again. That's the second penalty of the game here.
Now, if they blew the whistle because of the penalty, Arizona had the puck. So I don't
quite. I think it was offsides.
But it just happened to be at the penalty was called at the same time as the offside.
Right.
Penalty, 6:53 in the second period.
So that's a cross-checking and a power play for Arizona. Studioso goes to the box. So it must have been a delayed penalty. Arizona, the puck was going to Arizona, and then they were outside to whistle, and that's why the penalty is called then. Understood, and Arizona has the man advantage. big opportunity for them in this second period. Anthony Cuccinelli with the puck. He sends it off wide. There's a shot that Moore saw and was able to glove.
The Wildcats are moving the puck pretty well on their last two power plays. So that was a nice vision there from Cuccinelli to Marshall. I think Marshall just didn't really quite get a hold of that one.
Now, Anthony Cuccinelli is one of the most unselfish players, and he was looking to get the puck into a better scoring position. But, boy, he has such a good shot. I just like to see Anthony Cuccinelli shoot the puck.
Especially down on that left side as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's down there, and there was no one on him, and he had a clear shot. But you know what? He figured the goaltender could see that, too. He wanted to move the puck to a better scoring position, and Moore was there and made the save. Back to Cuccinelli now over the line with speed. He comes in and takes a tough angle shot. Moore's in position, and it goes all the way back down the ice. So there's an example of Cuccinelli on the break, and he did take a shot. Dangerous player. I just love to see Anthony Cuccinelli shoot the puck. Down to the last 1:05 to go on the power play for Arizona. Here's Cuccinelli with the puck over the blue line, looking to send it behind the net. Oh, over Bailey Marshall's stick. They're going to get the puck out of the zone. Holt cuts it off there and goes back the other way, but that completely disrupted the power play as ASU now comes over the line. That's Hoffenkamp. Hoffenkamp sends it in and gets a shot on goal. There's some good ragging time off the clock by Hoffenkamp. Last 40 seconds of the power play for the Arizona Wildcats. Down by a goal here in the second period, 11:40 to go. And Arizona really taking their time trying to get out of this zone. Pass to center ice to Chris Westland. And there's a rebound. Moore doesn't have his stick. But Arizona doesn't have the puck. So he can go behind the goal and get his stick. Another great opportunity lost there for the Arizona Wildcats, down to the last 7 seconds of the power play, and Arizona does not connect on the power play yet again. ASU regroups and sends it up over the Cats' blue line. Delayed offside on them, so they have to vacate. Arizona picks it up. It's Justin Plumhoff. Still a delayed, finally, and ASU, but that was a really long delayed offside. Usually, you know, if the guys won't vacate, they'll blow the whistle and call an offside there. They really allowed ASU to skate around for a while there before realizing that it was a delayed offside. Arizona State keeps the puck in, however. There's a save by Bivalsik. Arizona needs to get possession of this puck. They're just kind of watching the puck again as ASU sends it down low. There's a deflection that there's no way the Bivalsik could have seen, but it goes wide. Arizona picks it up and just sends it blindly up and not out. Now they finally get up out of the zone. And there's a hit on Dawson Marshall after he makes the pass. That was close to interference, but probably a beat or so within the rules. We're halfway home now, 9:55 to go in the period. We have another whistle. Arizona State with that 1-0 lead. Arizona needs to hit the ignition switch here. Will, they look, they might be stuck a little bit in neutral.
We talked about the consistency with the Wildcats and how they kind of are two different versions of this team so far into the season. We're kind of seeing that just in tonight's game as well. We're kind of seeing random spurts of greatness, and then out of nowhere they kind of take their foot off the gas. You'd like to try and see them kind of be a little bit more consistent in the actual game as well.
Well, I hope that's not the title of our season-ending highlight video. Random spurts of greatness by the Arizona Wildcats. As now Arizona is going to go into the box and down by a goal, Ethan Stahlhuth has taken a minor, 9:40 to go in the second period. Everything's starting to tilt a little bit towards ASU's style of play, and they have a very good power play. This is a big kill.
Absolutely, and for right now as well, something that I'm starting to notice as well, there's not there's a couple big hits, obviously, but there's not as many, you know, after the whistle kind of scrums or messes. And I wonder if some of the coaches were talking to their players about that.
Ethan Stahlhuth, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of that penalty, 10 minutes, 20 seconds in the second period.
So Stahlhuth in for roughing. As there's a shot, Bavalsik makes the save, but he gives up a rebound. Cats are able to get to it there. Are they going to be able to exit the zone? They don't. They get it to the blue line, but not out. That's Jack Howsworth moving it back to Howsworth in the center of the ice. It's a shot that goes high and wide. Whoa, that was a tough one. And can the Cats get it out here? They do. Chris Westland almost with a break there, but he does get the puck to center ice. I was going to go back and try to disrupt a Sun Devil, and here we're going to have an ASU penalty that will even this up. So the power play is negated for Arizona State. And Andrew Houston, who has the goal here tonight, he's not happy with that penalty at all. Zach Kowalchuk complaining about it to the referee, but you know, the referee for every hockey game ever keeps his record perfect. He has not changed his call because players have argued that it wasn't a call. Another power play for Arizona, but the puck comes out of the zone.
Andrew Houston, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalty, 11 minutes, 4 seconds in the second period.
Or rather, it will be a short-term power play for Arizona in another minute and four. It'll be a 44-second power play for Arizona. For now, we'll skate 4-on-4. And go back to the right of Nolan Bivalsik. Arizona down by a goal. Again, they'll have a short power play in about a minute. It's important that that got evened up because ASU is so dangerous on the power play, and they're calling Arizona offside at the blue line. You know, with how Arizona, kind of lethargically, Arizona's playing here, they could ill afford to go down by a couple goals here on home ice. 8:34 to go in the second period. Arizona trailing by a goal, skating 4-on-4 for another 45 seconds. Here's Elliot Plour just kind of falling on the puck, but it comes away. Now, you'd think that the 4-on-4 would benefit Arizona. They're a fast team, but guess what? Arizona State's a pretty darn fast team themselves. So there should be a little bit more ice here skating 4-on-4 here for the next 25 seconds. An attempt to feather the puck down low. Misses, and Manny Rowe knocks his man off the puck. There's the puck sitting there, and ASU comes away with the puck. They're going to try the stuff, and then an ASU player loses his stick, and now we're going to have a delayed penalty, a trip on Arizona. And now the parade to the box begins. I think that's Trey Decker going to the box.
Just a really sloppy last couple minutes here from Arizona. You know, they kind of got in their own way on an offsides call. And then on that one, too, just kind of, you know, diving out and jabbing your stick out there. I mean, that's one of those things for the last couple minutes. You can't be making mistakes like that.
So we'll skate 4-on-3 here.
2 minutes for tripping. Time of that penalty, 12 minutes, 19 seconds in the second period.
Well, we'll continue to skate 4-on-4 as the shot comes in on Moore as the one penalty expires. Arizona gets a man back. And then in 20 seconds, there'll be about a minute 10 power play for Arizona State. So 12 seconds from now, they'll have about a minute 10 power play. Arizona doing a good job of just ragging the puck there in the Arizona State end, however. A shot on goal that goes off the blocker of Moore. Boy, he's faced a lot of shots tonight, but he hasn't seen the lamp light behind him. As now the ASU breaks in 2-on-1. And there's a nice backhanded pass. Sun Devil taken out of the play. That could have been called a penalty, but it wasn't. ASU now on the power play for the next 50 seconds or so. And again, this is a huge kill for Arizona. 6:25 to go in the second period. Down by a goal. You know, and we haven't called Clayton Lackey's name a lot. He got some speed going up there, but they were just slightly, they were just offside, just slightly out of sync there. And that's lucky for the Cats, because when you see Lackey get that speed up with the puck, usually good things are going to happen for Arizona State.
I think they're calling an interference penalty here, Tim.
So it was more than an offside. Elliot Plourd heads back to the box.
Both teams kind of shooting themselves in the foot here.
So in 39 seconds, Arizona could have a minute and 20 or so of power play.
Elliot Plourd, 2 minutes for interference. Time of that penalty, 13 minutes, 40 seconds in the second period.
Well, it's been good news for Arizona that they've been able to at least cancel out these power plays. But they got to get something going here as the puck comes in and Moore makes a good save. Boy, that was an awfully quick whistle because he dropped that puck just as the whistle was blowing. In 16 seconds, we'll have a power play a little bit over a minute for Arizona. They need a man advantage now. They need someone to light a spark here for them. And this crowd wants something to happen.
Yeah, you can hear kind of like a pin drop in here right now. Yesterday's crowd was so into it, obviously, with the game being so great and back and forth. You want a big hit. You want something to kind of get the crowd going and get the team going as well.
Now it's time for a man advantage for a minute 20. Cats come over the line with the puck. Send to the far side. Back to Ben Jones right in the center of the ice. Here's to Cusinelli. Oh, his shot is blocked. That was a good idea. He was trying to get it down low. Cusinelli with the puck. Back to Jones. Jones sends it. It deflects in front right to the edge of the goal. Arizona retains possession. Back to Cusinelli. Cusinelli takes a shot, and boy, he finds an ankle with it. Goes over Ben Jones' stick.
Three blocked shots in a row there from Lackey.
Cusinelli now over the line again, moving the puck. Far side, there's a shot that deflects out of play, so we'll have a faceoff to the left of Bronson Moore. Still 38 seconds to go on the power play. Boy, Arizona needs something to happen, and this is just about the time of the game last night, about 5 minutes to go in the second period when they started to come on. Well, it's time to press that button, whatever that button was. We need to see them to turn it on again.
One of the most frustrating and on the other side, the one of the greatest feelings you can have is a hot goaltender, and you feel like Bronson Moore might be getting in the zone right now.
Absolutely right. Shot that comes in on Moore, and he gives up a rebound, but the Cats can't send it home. Arizona State's able to get it down the ice, and we'll have 20 seconds left on the power play. It's not that Moore, you know, he hasn't gobbled up all the pucks. There have been some rebounds. There have been some loose pucks. There just hasn't been an Arizona stick near those pucks last 10 seconds of the power play. Cusinelli with the puck up to Josh Larson over the blue line. Back to Cusinelli. He's knocked off of it, though. ASU gets the puck back out of the zone. Penalty is over. And here we got an Arizona player just taking out an ASU player right near the blue line. There's some frustration boiling over. Cats got to be careful here. They're going to go back to the box. I don't know exactly what happened. Happened there, but Justin Plumoff is going to go to the box, and it's not what you like to see out of your senior, although Drew Platt for ASU is also going to the box. So I didn't, you know how we talk about you often see the second action? Well, I saw the second action of the Arizona player pummeling on ASU. Well, the referee must have seen the first action because both players have gone off for roughing. Again, Arizona just very fortunate there that someone went to the box with them.
Yeah, they, one of those things that just kind of started with, I think it was just two guys that kind of just got into their way, and obviously when it's a rivalry game,
All it takes is one, you know, comment or one sort of thing to kind of get frustrations rising there. And I think that's kind of what just happened there. I think as far as everything that happened last night as well, I think having kind of the same reffing crew as well, I'm sure they're just, you know, both you guys go to the box. We're not doing this tonight.
So we'll have a face-off to the right of Nolan Bevalsik. Won by the Cats, Bailey Marshall. The puck sends it up the near side.
Drew Platt, 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty on number 19, Justin Plummo. 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty on number 15, Anthony Cusinelli. 2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalties, 15 minutes, 48 seconds in the second period.
So this is actually a power play for Arizona State. I didn't see the extra penalty, and it was on Anthony Cusinelli. He must be frustrated. He's not one to be in the box very often at all. And once again, we're back to a big kill for the Arizona Wildcats. Minute 15 to go on this power play. You know players are frustrated when Anthony Cusinelli ends up in the box. Another big kill for Arizona and a great opportunity for Arizona State. Sun Devils play so steady. Such a reflection of their coach, Tate Green, in the second year of his program and how he's transformed the feeling of this team. They're getting more confident. They play so steady. Very impressive hockey team, Arizona State. Last night, even though they didn't win that game, but here tonight, they're playing really well. Looking for their second goal as the puck is loose in the crease. Now there's an Arizona State player on top of the goaltender. Nolan Bevalsik takes umbrage with that. Maybe this will get the crowd going here a little bit. You can't hang all over the opposing goaltender like that. And expect nothing to happen.
Yeah, you know, we've seen Bevalsik kind of get testy in kind of some of these situations sometimes. And, you know, you love to see that fight out of your goaltender. You know, hopefully that kind of gets the guys going. Unfortunately, it does look like this is another Wildcat going. Here comes a Sun Devil as well. Another kind of offsetting penalty here. Things starting to kind of pick up, though, and frustration's definitely rising for Arizona. And you just hope that they can kind of wrangle that in and stay out of the penalty box.
Well, we'll see what the referee Tom Bibbs figures out about what's going to happen here. You know, you can't wail on the opposing goaltender like that after the whistle, and you can't, and you don't, you know, he's going to turn around and defend himself. But I'd be very surprised. Arizona has to come away with the, ASU has to come away with another power play out of this, I would think.
And we got four Wildcats in the penalty box right now, barely enough room for Manero to sit down.
Okay, this is a really dangerous part of the game for Arizona. They're probably going to be down by a couple men. There's 2:46 to go in this second period. They're down by a goal now. If they give up one or two in a string of power plays to Arizona State.
And we're talking about getting the crowd going. The crowd's kind of getting into it here. I mean, obviously with fighting and that kind of thing, that makes, you know, that makes a lot of the crowd kind of get more engaged, especially with a game when you're down 1-0.
Well, that was the most excited that we've seen this crowd all night because Nolan Bevalsik wanted to protect himself in the crease. Now, the goaltender's talking to him. I'm sure that one of these penalties is going to be on him. Someone else will serve it for Bevalsik, of course. But the referee's explaining to him, you know, when you try to chop wood like that on a guy's head, we're going to call something on you. And so explaining to Nolan Bevalsik. And indeed, a two-man advantage for 35 seconds to Arizona State. Critical face-off here now for Arizona, won by Arizona State.
And number 22, Braden Shaw, 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty on number 17, Ben Jones, 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty on number 35, Nolan Bevalsik. 2 minutes for roughing. Serving that penalty for Bevalsik is number 20, Manny Rowe. All penalties at 17 minutes, 14 seconds in the second period.
10 seconds to go on the two-man advantage. Arizona's done a good job of wasting some time here. But ASU now with the puck in the zone, right in the slot. And the puck goes wide. Arizona gets one player back. Power play still on for Arizona State. One man advantage for another 1:15 or so. They try to send it down low. So far, Arizona's been good on this penalty kill. Cats just try to pin it against the far boards. That shows you how strong Cameron Timor is. With two Sun Devils, he pinned it, but ASU comes away with it. It's right in the slot, and oh, thankfully, just goes wide for the Arizona Wildcats. ASU keeps it in, though. So dangerous on the power play to the far side. Now down to the low dot. Bounces off to the corner, down to the last 45 seconds of the power play, and it goes out of play, and Arizona can go for a change. 41 seconds to go in the power play, 1:27 to go in the second period. Now stick around, Cat fans, between the second and third period. We'll have more features and highlights about Arizona hockey, and then we'll talk to an Arizona player about this game so far, and we'll have that interview shortly before the start of the third period. But that's in a minute 27. That's how much time we have left here in the second period. 37 seconds to go on the power play. Big kill for the Arizona Wildcats, down by a goal against arch rival Arizona State. Looking good on the power play, but they haven't put the puck in the net yet. Being very careful, looking for that perfect shot as it comes in down low, and there's the rebound. But it comes out. Will it come out of the zone? It will come out of the zone. 1 minute to go in the second period. 14 seconds to go on the power play. This would be a huge emotional lift, Will, if they can kill off the rest of this power play.
Yeah, you know, yeah, last night's game, we saw Arizona score a goal right near the end of the period, and it kind of changed the momentum. And you'd like to think, you know, killing off a penalty right before the end of the period, it gives you that same sort of energy.
Well, the penalty is over. There's a Hedgecock. He was kind of sent to the ice, but no call. That's 35 seconds of the period. Arizona just needs to escape without any more damage here. They come away with the puck. That's Hedgecock with the puck behind his net up to Manny Rowe. He comes to his own blue line, now to the center line. Headmans it, tries to go for Dawson Marshall, but it's offside at the blue line. 19 seconds to go in the second period. Arizona trails 1-0 to Arizona State, and just like last night, the third period is going to tell the story of this game, and it's starting to heat up again. If this crowd can get into this game in this third period, maybe Arizona could create some momentum here. This is not going to be a happy locker room between the second and third period for the Arizona Wildcats. We have a whistle. We'll have another faceoff here. Now, on the other side of things, ASU has to be absolutely delighted. They've conducted the kind of game they want, the kind of style of game that they want.
I think they're happy, but I think they could be happier. I think the fact that it's still 1-0, I think that's a credit to the Wildcats for being able to kill off those penalties and keep it where it is. But I think Arizona also is kind of lucky and fortunate to only be down one right now.
I think you're absolutely right. Arizona very fortunate now here. That's 10 seconds of the second period. Cusinelli with the puck. He tried to get it down low, but it didn't get through. 2-1. That's going to do it for the second period. As number 22, Braden Shaw kind of gave a stick there to Cameron Timor. He just skates away. Smart thing to do.
Shots on goal in the second period. Arizona State with 13. Arizona with 16. The score after.
So Arizona with 16 shots on goal in that second period. ASU with 13. But the shot that counts is the one that went in the net by Andrew Husted. In the first minute of that second period to give Arizona State that 1-0 lead, and that's how it ends after two periods of play. Like I said, I don't think anyone wants to be within earshot of the Arizona locker room. I think there's going to be some bad words said here between the second and third period.
I think there's a lot of things that Arizona could definitely clean up. I mean, this is just a completely different game all around compared to last night's. You know, the crowd did kind of pick up their energy level there at the end. But like I said, the score only being 1-0, I think, is extremely fortunate for the Arizona Wildcats. I mean, on the other side, you did mention ASU should definitely be happy of where they're at. They're in total control of the game. They look calm. They have a nice presence on the puck. But on the other end, Arizona was very, very sloppy, picked up a lot of penalties, and I think they're very lucky to be only down 1-0 right now.
Well, and that's where we are at the end of two periods of play. It's number 7, Arizona scoreless, and number 10, Arizona State 1. Now stick around, we're going to have features and highlights about U of A hockey, and then we'll return shortly before the beginning of the third period with an interview with a Wildcat player and get his thoughts about tonight's game. You are watching University of Arizona Wildcats Hockey. It's time for another Arizona Wildcat Hockey, this or that.
Crosby or Ovechkin?
Probably gonna have to go Crosby.
Why?
I mean, he's literally like the champion of everything. He's won everything. He's got gold, he's got Stanley Cup, heart, everything.
Mighty Ducks or Blades of Glory?
Ooh, can't go wrong with Will Ferrell. I'm gonna have to go Blades of Glory for sure.
Dogs or cats?
Dogs. I like dogs a little better. Bigger size, everything. Yeah. I don't know.
Boxers or Commando?
I like to wear Lulus a lot, so definitely Commando.
Oh, wow. Okay. Why?
They got like the liners and stuff inside, so it's comfy. Might as well.
Blondes or brunettes?
I'm a brunette, so I like brunette.
Okay. USA or Canada?
Canada.
Why?
I'm Canadian.
Where in Canada are you from?
Victoria, BC.
Okay.
So we go Canada.
Bench or penalty box?
Bench.
Why?
Usually penalty means you did something bad, so.
Your hockey team. Your Arizona Wildcats. Call 791-4101 for tickets now.
There is no doubt that number 16, Kelly Walker, is the best of the best. Kelly, when I think of you, I think of the love and the commitment and the greatness you achieved here, right on this ice. Kelly and his teammates were 24-0 versus ASU over that four-year stretch. Please direct your attention to the south end of the Tucson Arena as we now reveal the banner honoring Kelly Walker. Please welcome back to the ice of the Tucson Arena, number 16, Kelly Walker.
You guys have a chance to show this town college hockey at the greatest level that you guys play. So I'm just extremely humbled to be here, to be in front of you guys, and to be in front of this whole great arena. And it's a very emotional moment for me. I'd like to thank my girlfriend, Andrea. I'd like to thank my line mates, Corey, Johnny, Johnny Wags, Goltzy, Danny Anderson, certainly Tommy Smith. I want to mention thanks to the great presentation that Tim did for me today. I want to thank Coach Firms. I want to make special recognition to Shane Fossell. And I also like to take recognition for every other player who has played here at the University of Arizona, who's proud to have played for the University of Arizona, and who continues to support this great program going forward and in the future. So guys, thank you so much for the tribute. Thanks for the support. Love you guys. Thank you very much.
Stay right there. We're perfect. We're perfect. Colorado State's on first, guys. Good work.
Camera 16.
Longtime Arizona hockey fans might remember that I was the media director for the team for the first time in the late 1990s, and I found a recruiting video that I made for the team in the year 2000. Now, in the 1980s and 1990s, as college hockey got more popular, it was common for colleges to put the word ice in front of their nickname. So Arizona State were the Ice Devils, and Arizona were the Ice Cats, and that's the name that you'll see in this recruiting video, which was made a full 10 years before Arizona adopted their regular Wildcat nickname. So let's get in the time machine and go back to the year 2000 and see this Arizona hockey recruiting video. Located in central Tucson on 352 acres, the University of Arizona is one of the top-ranked universities in the nation. Surrounded by soaring mountains in the Sonoran Desert, the campus boasts lush lawns, palm trees, and more than 300 days of sunshine each year. More than 35,000 undergraduate and graduate students attend the U of A, coming from all 50 states and more than 100 foreign countries. Arizona also has one of the most successful collegiate men's ice hockey programs in the United States, the Arizona Ice Cats.
It's a new season, a new century. But you still can't beat this cat. It's the 21st season of Arizona Ice Cat College Hockey. 18 home games at the TCC with four matchups against arch rival ASU.
The Arizona Ice Cats compete in Division I of the American Collegiate Hockey Association, the ACHA. All home games are played in the 7,000-seat Tucson Convention Center near the U of A campus. More than 1 million fans have packed the TCC over the years to watch Arizona Ice Cat hockey. That's an average of 5,000 fans a game, making the Ice Cats one of the top five draws in the U.S. for collegiate hockey at any level.
Paul, for those who haven't seen what it's like to have 7,000 people at the Tucson Convention Center to cheer for the Arizona Ice Cats against a team like arch rival ASU, for instance, can you tell them what kind of madhouse it is to see the Ice Cats play in front of 7,000 home fans?
Well, it's dubbed the Madhouse on Main Street here at the TCC, and when you come in, even if you come in for a game where we'll play a St. Louis University or something, you know, that's not a big rival of ours, we're still going to have 4,000, 5,000 people in the stands, you know, screaming your name. You get to see signs with your name on it. It's uncomparable to anything I've ever had before I got here. The biggest crowd I ever played in front of was maybe 400 or 500 people in high school, a big high school rivalry.
I'm sure you were told there were 6,000 or 7,000 people for some of the games here at Arizona, but were you still surprised when you walked out onto the ice the first time in front of that many people?
Oh, for sure. I mean, it's one thing being able to sit in the stands with the 6,000 people and watching, you know, the team play. It's one thing, another thing to step on the ice in front of that many people, and it's just nuts. It's you know, the crowd's screaming, you know, you're the home team, and you know, you got your arch rival ASU down there, and just to be able to play in front of that crowd, it's pretty nervous, pretty nerve-wracking your first time out.
It is the most exciting feeling there is against Arizona State to score a big goal. I can't explain it. You get jumped on by your players. I mean, 7,000 fans cheering for you. It was a great experience. It happened to me last year twice, two games in a row, and it was just the greatest feeling of the year by far.
In this ACHA, you've got Penn State, Ohio State, Michigan, Dearborn, on and on, Iowa State. I mean, we're talking about some of the biggest hockey colleges in the country, which we play. We have a graduation rate that is far better than any other sport on the University of Arizona campus. And needless to say, they gotta be an excellent hockey player. We have young men that come out of junior A's. We've had some that come down from Division I, quote unquote, big schools, which we play anyway. But they'd much rather play here in front of 6,800 people than play in front of 1,000. There is, I guarantee you, not a fan in the country that matches our fans when it comes to making noise, bar no place in the country.
Founded in 1979, the Ice Cats' numbers are staggering. More than 400 wins, a record 18 consecutive national tournament appearances, 8 Final Four appearances, and the 1985 National Collegiate Club Championship.
Mark, talk about the travel that this team takes, because many teams will play just their closest neighbors, but the Arizona Ice Cats fly all over the country to play games. Talk about the opportunities you have to play the best teams in the country.
We go on road trips all the time during the year. I mean, a lot of fun. We go all to Penn State, make it down to Chicago, out in the Midwest, California, we travel all over. We just get to play the best competition.
Are you glad you came to Tucson, Arizona, attend the University of Arizona, and play for the Arizona IceCats?
Oh, definitely. It's one of the best decisions I've ever made. You get to wear sandals and shorts to the rink every day and have fun playing hockey, and the school itself's a great school to go to.
Here's Bailey Marshall, the star from Central Oklahoma. Back to Cusinelli, the all-everything star for Arizona. Down to Chris Westland, who sends it in on goal. That's a good idea, and it's right in the slot. And it's a goal for Arizona! I think that's Bailey Marshall. Bailey Marshall, who already had a couple goals last week for Arizona. And that's a big one for the Arizona Wildcats. They even this at 1-1 in the second period.
To go in the period. There's a high hard shot that's just kind of sitting around in the crease. Where's it? It's in the net. That's a goal! Arizona scores the first goal!
As the Cats go on the man advantage, get the puck up behind the blue line. Down low to Cusinelli. Shoot the puck, Anthony. He does. That's a beautiful shot. Shoot the puck. Anthony Cusinelli scored the goal. Anthony Cusinelli. Arizona takes a 3-0 lead. Wow!
That's an excellent look by Cusinelli. You saw him look for the pass first, but then he was aware. He had a clear shooting lane, and he took it, and he's one of those guys that can put it just where he wants it.
Anthony Cusinelli turns with it. Oh, Nick gets shot. It gets tipped in. Anthony Cusinelli just threw it towards the net, and I think Bailey Marshall may have tipped that one in. Up the near side boards. That's come away with it. Justin Plumhoff, the goal. I'm not sure if that's Justin Plumhoff's goal.
I think that might have been Trey Decker. I'm not quite sure, but
I think Decker just threw that in front and it bounced in.
There's a nice possession of the puck. That can't happen. Cats come over the blue line.
And they shoot, they score! They shoot, they score! Arizona scores! And that puck was given up. We talked about mistakes. Wow, what a mistake right in front of Joshua George. Anthony Cusinelli had a good shot there, but George saw it and made the save. You know, Anthony Cusinelli, I think, just needs to shoot the puck a little bit more like he did there. He switches now to the center of the ice. Take the shot, Anthony. And he shoots, he scores! Anthony Cusinelli! He shoots, he scores! Welcome back to the Tucson Arena. We're between periods 2 and 3 between number 7 Arizona and number 10 Arizona State. ASU with a 1-0 lead after 2 periods of play. And our Jackson Peters caught up with Chris Westland of the Wildcats to talk about tonight's game. Let's hear from Chris Westland about tonight's game.
Hi, I'm Jackson Peters, and I'm joined here with Christopher Westland of the University of Arizona Wildcats. And after 2 periods here at the Tucson Arena, the Cats are trailing the Arizona State University Sun Devils by a score of 1-0. Now, Christopher, big 5-on-3 penalty kill there at the end. Is that going to be enough to give you guys some momentum going into the third period here?
Yeah, you know, I think so. It gives us a lot of energy there. Obviously, in the third, we got to stay out of the box a little bit. But, you know, I like our chances going into this. We got a little bit of a hot goalie on their end, but just got to keep putting pucks on net. We'll be good.
Yeah, and you talk about a hot goalie, but, you know, you guys have to stay out of the box, like you said. Is that going to be the biggest key in the third period, or is there something else?
Absolutely. You know, discipline is huge. You know, we just got to keep going, though, and just keep working. We have a lot of faith in this locker room. I really think we can do it here.
Well, we've been speaking with Christopher Westland. We'll send it back to the booth with Tim Gasson.
Welcome back to the Tucson Arena. I'm Timothy Gasson along with Will Harmon, getting ready for the third period of play between Arizona and Arizona State. And, Will, I think we summed it up pretty well when we said that ASU is playing the style of game that they want to play. They're kind of dictating this game to the Arizona Wildcats so far. Arizona fortunate to only be down by a goal with the period to go.
Yeah, the Wildcats, I think, again, we said it, are generally pretty lucky to be going into the third period here only down one. But on the other end, you know, ASU really took control of the game. They have a nice calm presence to them. And obviously they're happy to be in the lead going into the third period here. But I think they maybe are a little bit frustrated too that they aren't leading by a little bit more. I think Arizona has really only had a handful even, maybe not even that many, of scoring chances. And I think ASU, when that's going that way for Arizona, I think ASU is maybe frustrated that they aren't taking more advantage of those kind of situations. And Arizona's definitely going to need to make a lot of adjustments here coming into the third period if they want to win this game.
Well, it sounds like, Will, you're a glass half full kind of guy. The idea that Arizona's only down by one goal, because I think you're right. I think ASU could have jumped up on top of Arizona by two or three or four goals. So Arizona, it is fortunate that they only have a one-goal deficit. But this is one of those games where this one-goal deficit seems to have this giant weight on the shoulders of the Wildcats. It is just one goal. That is just one shot. But Arizona not able to dent the net yet.
Yeah, no, and they've had several power play opportunities there for both squads, but and that was one of the things that we had spoke with ASU about before the game as well. You know, they're doing a lot better on killing off those power plays and not really getting letting Arizona kind of get set up. And I think if there are more penalties here in this third period, you know, that's the kind of thing that Arizona is going to need to take advantage of if they want to get on the scoring board because it hasn't really been coming from anywhere else, and you need some sort of a spark, and I think that's the type of thing that could get it going for them.
Well, you're absolutely right. They need a spark, and there are the boos, and the boos can mean only one thing. Arizona State University has taken the ice for the third period of play. Arizona, in the distance, I can see them leaving their locker room. They're your hometown hockey team, your Arizona Wildcats. Support your Wildcats and call now for tickets to see Arizona hockey at the Tucson Arena. Call 791-4101 now and bear down. And we need the Wildcats to bear down right now as they take the ice for the third period of play. 20 minutes is a long time in a hockey game, Will, but they're going to have to break some tendencies here. They're going to have to stay out of the box, and they're going to have to bury those pucks that are just outside the reach of their sticks. And possibly something lucky needs to bounce for them, too.
Yeah, definitely a lucky bounce. Some bodies in front of the net is one of those kind of things. It's one of the – they had a couple breakaway chances as well, some two-on-ones and three-on-ones even going. And those are kind of the opportunities that if those do arise, they're going to need to take advantage of those as well. Bronson Moore, though, through two periods has been playing excellent hockey in the net there for ASU, coming up with several big saves, had that fully stretched out save to kind of rob one of the Wildcats in that second period. So if he keeps playing like that, it's going to be difficult for Arizona to get anything going.
You know, I've talked about over the decades, beating ASU has been one of my greatest hockey highlights. Well, tell you what, when you lose to Arizona State, that's as low as you can get as an Arizona Wildcat. Of course, it's the same thing for Sun Devil fans as well. There's nothing as exhilarating as beating your rival and nothing as bad as losing to them. Well, Arizona State has a one-goal lead entering the third period. The puck is down and we are underway. Luckily, the penalty boxes are empty to start this third period. Timothy Gasson here along with Will Harmon bringing you the action along with our entire Arizona hockey media crew as Nolan Bavalsik makes a glove save and will have a faceoff to his left. Just 34 seconds into this third period. Well, the third period was an exhilarating one for Arizona fans last night in the big 6-4 victory for the Cats. We'll have to see if it's time to cheer again in the third period or not for Arizona as they win the faceoff. Goes over to Chris Westland, who talked to us shortly before this third period. Here's a long stretch pass that doesn't connect to Anthony Cusinelli. Cats regroup, Manny Rowe with the puck. Chris Westland sends it in. Now here's Bailey Marshall, center of the ice with the puck. Bailey Marshall, the shot goes wide. I don't know how many opportunities Bailey Marshall is going to have in the slot with the puck like that. As it goes to the center or the back of the net. Marshall keeps it in briefly. He's got to be careful not to pick up an interference penalty there as Andrew Husted comes over the line with the puck. Arizona responds and picks it up now. Palmley comes to center ice, but it bounces right back into the Arizona zone, 2-on-1. And there's the puck that goes feathers to the far post. Lucky that a Sun Devil wasn't there to tap that home.
Clayton Lackey was wide open there breaking in, and that's an unfortunate fan there for ASU.
Play continues on as the puck comes down low and behind the net, misses the net. Josh Larson digs for it there, and you can hear how quiet and expectant this crowd is as the puck comes out to center ice. You know, Justin Dungy made a smart decision there. You could have left your skates and tried to keep that puck in. Most likely that's going to deflect to an ASU player who's going to have a break all the way down on the ice. No use trying to leave your feet and try to keep that puck in the zone, but nothing good really is going to come from that play. Some of the crowd kind of groaned at that. Here come the Cats over the blue line. A backhander that goes off of Moore behind the net. Bronson Moore playing so well in goal for Arizona State. He did last night, gave up some goals, however. It didn't look like he had a great night, but we knew he had this kind of effort in him. So far, pitching the shutout, and there, I've cursed him. I have called it a shutout. Anytime you do that, the hockey gods will usually allow a goal to go in, and right off of that, there's a good opportunity there for Arizona. We'll see if the hockey gods are listening to my blasphemy as the puck bounces out of play, but I don't know how many times I've ruined a goaltender shutout by saying the word shutout on a broadcast. That's one of those old superstitions. Of course, I would never say that if Arizona goalie had not given up a goal. And of course, it makes absolutely no difference whether I say it or not, but it's the third period of a rivalry game, and we're pulling out everything that we can. ASU with a one-goal victory, a well-deserved one, a one-goal lead over the University of Arizona Wildcats. Well-deserved a lead. They've played an excellent road game here as they pick up the puck at center ice, move it up over the blue line, send it wide of the goal. Cats make a hit there and get it down the ice. They should wave off the ice, but they're going to call this an icing.
Maybe beats it
out. It was waved off. One linesman was calling it an ice, the other one waved it off. Comes in on Moore, and he swallows up that puck, and so we'll have another faceoff. 16:37 to go in the game. A lot of time to go. Like in the first period, both benches on their feet. Every faceoff, every penalty, every play, every mistake becomes so important now in a one-goal game. That puck comes in on Moore. He's not sure where it is. And I don't think the whistle blew. I guess it did. The Arizona player I don't think heard the whistle. Some Arizona State players were a little upset about that. But no harm, no foul. We'll continue on. 16:28 to go in the game. We'll have a faceoff to the right of Bronson Moore. You know, those 23 shots in the first period, it showed you you have to have quality shots, not just get the puck on net. It's another argument we can have sometime. Is any shot a good shot? Or is moving the puck to a better position, taking that chance and not getting a shot on goal, but getting it in a better position, the better idea? I think both are good answers, actually. But the 23 shots in the first period showed Arizona with no goals out of that. You got to get some quality scoring chances. There's an Arizona player just wrestled to the ice there by Hoffenkamp. No call. The puck goes wide, and Manny Rowe has to regain at center ice to Bailey Marshall. He shovels it down low. You know, Manny Rowe with the puck again. We talked yesterday about the maturity of the Arizona Wildcats. Did they have it when the going gets tough? They had it last night. This is a new night, a new game. Down by a goal to Arizona State. Here comes the Cats with some speed. The puck goes wide off of Justin Dungy's stick. Good individual effort, though. He has it again. Good defensive effort there, getting a stick on that shot. Cats showing some urgency here, though, in the ASU zone. They got to be careful not to give up. Odd man rushes going the other way off of that kind of urgency as Hedgecoke turns with the puck, goes up the near side boards. Cats with some speed over the blue line, but Alex Johansson tried to pull that puck back, and it was taken off of his stick. Nice defensive play there by the Sun Devils, and they come right back the other way. Arizona recovers, though. Sends it up to Max Meyer. Meyer had a great game last night. Could use a little bit of that magic right now. It's like, you know, when we have those games where Arizona wins 9-1, I always wish we could save one or two of those goals in a little bag and pull them out when we need them, because you know there's going to be times when every hockey team needs a goal, and Arizona needs a big goal. Shot comes in on Moore, and he makes the save. It doesn't have to be a perfect play. It doesn't have to be a perfect shot, but Arizona has to turn that lamp on. Now, so many guys, Bailey Marshall and Anthony Cusinelli come to mind. Those two guys come up with these big goals when their team needs them. And we need something like that right now as the puck bounces around yet again in front of Moore. There is more traffic going on in front of Moore. He's having to make more difficult saves here. Arizona's got to get one by him. So it's feathered down low and it comes in on Moore. And he falls on it. We'll have a whistle. Now players have to be careful after the whistle not to do stupid stuff and pick up a penalty.
Yeah, we haven't seen too much of that tonight, and hopefully that kind of stays the same way. You feel like, you know, what we're talking about with the puck kind of bouncing the wrong way or the right way, if you're a Wildcats fan, you know, it's one of those things that's the type of goal that I feel like is, if the Wildcats are going to get on the scoreboard, that it's going to come from. It's going to be bodies in front of the net. It's going to be kind of the puck dribbling the wrong way. Then again, I'm sitting up in the booth and I'm not playing, so I could be wrong.
No, I think you're absolutely right. This is one, there's going to be no cheap goal if Arizona can score here. Tonight they're going to have to earn it the hard way. ASU is playing the best game that I've seen them play in years. I said that again last night. They did have a one-goal lead. The puck just goes wide. There's a nice opportunity there for Arizona. They just couldn't finish the deal last night. 13:40 to go in the game here. The puck comes back in on Moore. Cats are really putting on some good pressure now, though. They're putting on the best pressure that they have in the game. A lot of time left in this. They have to show some urgency. They got to show that they're a veteran club now, playing on home ice. A lot of firepower on this club.
A lot of time has been spent down here in the ASU zone. You'd like to see that. And a lot of pretty decent scoring chances as well for the Wildcats.
And we got an ice on Arizona State. Now, these icing calls are going to be important here in the third period as the teams are tired. Second game in two nights. And, of course, on an ice, the offending team has to stay on the ice. You can have some tired guys, especially late in the game, trying to relieve that pressure and icing the puck. So keep an eye on that. Arizona digging for the puck on the near side boards for Arizona, but ASU is able to get out to center ice. No, they don't get it out. It's right at the blue line and kept in. Goes down low. Arizona is going to go for it there. Trying to pin it, trying to move it. Cats come away with it briefly, but now here's a two-on-one break for ASU. Comes in on the winger, and as we said, that Clayton Lackey hasn't been talked about much here tonight. The puck comes over to him on the two-on-one on break, and he buries it for a 2-0 Arizona State lead.
Two of our guys that we highlighted last night's game specifically, and then tonight as well, plored to Lackey there. You saw what they're capable of, and you saw, you know, how quickly, you know, things can, they can develop those plays. They can get out and they can break out really quickly, and that's kind of what happened there. You know, Bavalsik's played pretty well as well, but that's one of those things. It's a breakaway chance. You know, there's not too much you can really do about that, but just try it and get in the right way.
Clayton Lackey, the assist goes to number 11, Elliot Plored. That's Lackey from Plored. Time of the Sun Devil goal, 7 minutes in the third period.
Clayton Lackey, so dangerous. Yeah, we talked to him earlier tonight on the broadcast, what an addition to this ASU squad. He showed it last night, and he had been quiet here tonight. But he scores a big second goal for Arizona State. They now have a two-goal lead on the road, 12 and a half minutes to go in the game. They've been in control of this game, and now we're going to have an elbow, and I think this is going to go on Arizona State. Here's an opportunity. Here's an opportunity. Drew Platt going to the box for Arizona State. So U of A will get this much-needed power play. 12:22 to go in the game. ASU just scored that all-important second goal to have a two-goal lead here. I'm not saying this is a must-have with this much time left.
Drew Platt, 2 minutes for elbowing. Time of that penalty, 17 minutes, 38 seconds.
But it's getting close to that, Will, where the Cats have to show, put some pressure on, and make something happen.
Yeah, this is their opportunity to really get that all-important goal in those dangerous 2-0 leads like we talk about.
This doesn't seem like a very dangerous two-goal lead.
Yeah,
this is one of these two-goal leads that seems like 3 or 4 goals here.
Yeah, but, I mean, at the end of the day, it is still 2-0, and you'd like to see Arizona take advantage of that and get that all-important goal on that 2-0 deficit.
They have an opportunity here with the man advantage to cut this in half. Anthony Cusinelli out with the first line on the power play. Puck comes off of Cusinelli's stick, however, and ASU comes back the other way. Ben Jones seals off his man, and Arizona picks up the puck. There's a slash. There's a second slash by Hoffenkamp. Nothing called. Marshall with the puck. Over to the center of the ice to Ben Jones. Over to Cusinelli. Marshall shoots it wide, and it comes out to center ice. Hoffenkamp was slashing all the way back to the defensive zone. Nothing called. Fortunate for Arizona State as Arizona comes back over the line. There's Marshall with the puck. He takes the shot in on goal. A nice big rebound, but no Arizona stick there. The puck comes out of play, and we'll have another faceoff in the Arizona State zone to the left of Bronson Moore, who so far has to be the player of the game. I got to believe, Will.
Yeah, absolutely. He's looked. I mean, we talked about how calm Arizona State has looked on the with the lead and not, you know, looking panicky or anything. How about that for Bronson Moore? I mean, he's been totally composed in that, and he is definitely in the zone right now. He's going to be tough to beat.
Matthew Hull with the puck sends it down low. And there's a shot, and finally a goal! A goal for Arizona. I think that's going to be Justin Plumhoff. The puck was moved to the far dot. Went down low, and then, oh yeah, Justin Plumhoff comes up with the rebound and finally solves Bronson Moore. And once again, the curse holds. The shutout is broken. 11:06 to go in the game. Arizona back in it, down by a goal. ASU 2, Arizona 1. So the Cats right back in on this. This should get the crowd going.
Arizona Wildcat goal. Give it to number 19, Justin Plumhoff. The assist goes to number 9, Cameron Timor, and number 13, Matthew Hull. That's Plumhoff from Timor and Hull. Time of your Wildcat power play goal, 8 minutes 54 seconds. In the third period.
He shoots, he scores. Now suddenly that two-goal lead, now it's a 2-1 lead. Now it seems like anything is possible. It's amazing how there's a different outlook on the game. When it was 1-0, it seemed like Arizona could do nothing. Now they're still down by a goal, but they had scored. Now there's some renewed energy. 10 minutes to go in this game now. It's anyone's game.
Energy in the building is just completely shifted here. You got 10 minutes left in this third period, and the bench is fired up, and so is the Wildcats team. You know, that was one of those moments that that's one of the resiliency things that we had discussed at the top of the game.
10:04 to go. in this game. Arizona trailing by a goal. Face off to the left of Bronson Moore. He's played great tonight, but he has been solved for at least one goal. Cats have to stay out of the box here, and they're going to go right to the box as soon as I say that with a tripping call in the offensive zone. I don't blame Ethan Stahlhuth for being upset as he slams his stick going in to the box. He just couldn't disengage there, and that has to be called. So there's only 9:52 in the game, and the Cats are going to waste at least a couple minutes of this.
Ethan Stahlhuth, 2 minutes for hooking. Time of the penalty, 10 minutes, 8 seconds in the third period.
Trying to kill a power play. They need those 2 minutes to try to get that equalizer. Let's see if they can kill off this penalty. Big power play for Arizona State.
We just talked about the momentum and the energy in the room kind of changing after that Wildcats goal. There's no bigger momentum killer than picking up a penalty immediately after scoring a goal like that.
Well, especially with the puck going the other way, you're not going to keep that puck in the offensive zone. There was really nothing to be gained from it, and Stahlhuth just couldn't disengage, and he was going to be called for that penalty. Now Arizona has to kill this off. The puck goes high into the corner. 1:15 to go on the power play for Arizona State. ASU turns. Go all the way around the net, and there's a shot. There's a save by Bavalsic. That ASU player was allowed to dance all the way around the net, turn and fire. So dangerous. 1:02 to go on the man advantage. 8:54 to go in the game. You know, we can't expect any less when these two teams play. It always is gritty. It's always passionate and emotional. And this year, I mean, this ASU team is so composed. And with the talent to back up that composure, let's see if Arizona is equal for the next 55 seconds of this power play. Puck comes down low and just squirts wide to the near side corner, back behind the net. Cats have to be careful here not to watch the puck too much as Manny Rowe tries to go for the puck, comes out to the blue line. 35 seconds to go in the center of the ice now, up high. And the Cats are able to get the puck down the ice. 25 seconds to go on the man advantage for Arizona State. 8:10 to go in the game. We're getting on to crunch time. Arizona needs a goal. They need no more men in the penalty box. Last 10 seconds of this penalty, ASU pretty content to just take a little bit of time off the clock. Now get it up to the Arizona blue line to the center of the ice, and it's pinballing around there. ASU comes away. There's the end of the penalty, but Arizona State has the puck and deflects it over the net. Dangerous sequence there for Arizona, but they kill that penalty. 7:35 to go in the game. They need a goal. Having a little trouble getting out of their own end, however. Now they move up 3-on-2. Try to go through the center of the ice. Anthony Cusinelli 1-on-2 and wasn't able to do that. So the Cats just fire it in. Not very deep, though, and ASU's able to send it right back down. Now ASU, you know, they can put all their attention on playing defense as Dawson Marshall tries to come in, and he's taken down. He's trying to disengage, and the referee's right there, so he does and can. He goes to the bench, and Arizona goes for a partial change. It's Alex Johansson coming on for Marshall. Oh, and there's a shot that was teed up and missed by Johansson, but the Cats are able to, no, they aren't able to get the puck. The puck's in the slot. Arizona gets it now. Down to 6:30 to go in the game. Arizona needs a goal. There's a backhander from Jesse Lowell. Gobbled up by Bronson Moore, and we'll have a face-off to his right. 6:23 to go in the game. Now stick around, Cat fans. Win or lose, after the game, we'll go to center ice for post-game interviews and then have our post-game report from here in the press box. That's in 6 minutes and 23 seconds of playing time. Unless, of course, we have overtime. Arizona trailing by 1. There is a 5-minute overtime. This is a league game. This is a WCHL game. So there's also a shootout. Arizona back over the blue line. A shot that goes wide off of Alex Johansson's stick. 6 minutes to go in the game. Can Arizona get the equalizer? And Hoffenkamp is just holding the Wildcat there. Again, no call. And now there's a Wildcat taken down at the blue line, no call. Puck comes out to center ice. Arizona's going to have to vacate the zone. Down to 5.5 minutes to go in the game. Puck comes to the ASU blue line, but nothing comes of that, and it's just dumped right back down into the Arizona end of the ice. 5:20 to go in the game. We'll have to watch and see, when does Arizona call its timeout? If it needs to, when does it pull its goaltender? There's a long pass that's intercepted by ASU, and they come right in. Taken away again by the Cats. Timor picks it up there and just throws it down low. 4:50 to go in the game. Arizona needs something to happen here. And ASU needs absolutely nothing to happen. They just need to stay out of the box and play defensive hockey. And this will be a huge victory for them. There's an attempt to feather a backhand pass down low past two defenders. That's probably not going to happen, and it didn't. Manny Rowe tries to headman the puck up the blue line. He's being held. And there's Josh Larson, the goal! Josh Larson! The puck just kind of came in on him. I can't believe it! Josh Larson, the puck just kind of squirted over to him. And he took a swipe at it, and it just rolls in. Of all the goals to be scored by the Arizona Wildcats. 4:19 to go in the game, and we're all tied up. I can't believe it, Will.
I can't either. I mean, that, right before that happened, I was just about to say how much more difficult it was for the Wildcats to get through the neutral zone after killing that penalty. I mean, they were getting bumped off the blue line really easily, and that's one of those plays. The puck just kind of bounced in there.
Well, we said we might need a little luck or something. Well, the puck just barely had enough energy on it off the stick.
Arizona Wildcat goal, give it to number 6, Josh Larson. The assist goes to number 19, Justin Plumhoff, and number 20, Manny Rowe. That's Larson from Plumhoff and Rowe. Time of your Wildcat goal, 15 minutes, 41 seconds in the third period.
He shoots. He scores, and immediately Arizona goes back to the penalty box on an interference call. 3:52 to go in the game, and Arizona goes to the box on an interference call. You know, we said maybe there's a little bit of luck, and that's Matthew Hull that's going to go to the box. Maybe a little luck was needed. Well, that was a little bit of luck to get that equalizer, but 3:52 in the game, and Arizona has handed a gift to Arizona State, another power play.
Hole, 2 minutes for interference. Time of that penalty, 16 minutes, 8 seconds in the third period.
Can the Cats dodge one more bullet? 1:40 to go on the power play for Arizona State, and the puck comes out to center ice. Lucky break there on Clayton Lackey. Oh, and Manny Rowe just bumped Lackey off the puck, but he might get the last laugh here as he comes back with the puck the other way. Lackey very dangerous. He takes another hit. Manny Rowe lined him up there, but the Cats have to be careful here. They got to get the puck out of the zone, and they do. think Lackey's at the end of his shift, and he's looking over at the Arizona Wildcats. Who's going to hit me next? Lackey almost had the last laugh there because he came away with the puck.
Yeah,
and some space and speed up the ice.
I was watching Timor and Rowe there. Timor just gave him a little pat on the head. What a shift there from Manny Rowe. That was just absolute energy, top to bottom, flying up and down, and that's the kind of shift that obviously just got the crowd going as well.
Crowd with the U of A chant. 2:35 to go in the game, 44 seconds to go on the power play. Arizona has to kill this off. Boy, the crowd is into this now. So there's another hit at the blue line, and Arizona is able to clear the zone. ASU over the line with the puck, though. Comes to the near side. Are the Cats going to be able to get it out? Oh, that was almost a break for Bailey Marshall. He almost tapped it to himself. ASU back over the line, getting it down low. And there's a shot that goes wide. 14 seconds to go on the power play. Cats have to get this puck out of the zone. Instead, ASU is going to move it in front of the net. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Last 2 minutes of the game. 2-1. That's it for the penalty. Well, we have a whistle. We have a whistle. I think a couple guys are going to be tossed here, one from each team. Although I only see a Sun Devil heading to the box. No, here we go. 1:51 to go in the game. The power play for Arizona State is now over. So we're going to skate 4-on-4 here, I believe, for the remainder of regulation.
Wildcats really fortunate there to not give up a goal. Drew Platt had an opportunity to just kind of dribble off his stick there. I think he probably could have put that in the net there. I think Wildcats kind of came away with one there.
Absolutely right. Great opportunity for Arizona State. So now we're going to skate 4-on-4 for the remainder of regulation. And I don't know who this benefits. Both teams with a lot of speed. There's going to be a little bit more ice now, but we...
Braden Shaw, 2 minutes for cross-checking. Wildcat penalty on number 9, Cameron Timor. 2 minutes for slashing. Both penalties at 18 minutes, 9 seconds in the third period.
So if this game is tied at the end of regulation, there will be a 5-minute overtime. If it's tied at the end of the overtime, it'll be considered an ACHA tie for computer ranking purposes. But for the WCHL, there'll be a shootout to determine the winner or the loser of the game. But, the puck just goes off the post there. Now we're going to have at least one penalty and a couple penalties as there's a fight in the crease or some pushing and shoving and pawing. And there's some pawing in the far corner as well. As Matthew Hull just took a shot to the face. To finish my thought, if it goes to a shootout, the shootout is for the WCHL win or loss standings. The WCHL is based on a winning percentage this year, so they have to have a winner or a loser for every game. But for the ACHA, it'll be a tie. That's why Arizona has a tie against Arizona State in the ACHA standings and a shootout loss against Arizona State in the WCHL standings. So we're going to fill up the box with some guys. I don't think anyone's going to get an advantage out of this. The crowd sure is yelling like something good is going to happen for Arizona here, but I think they were just happy to see Zachary Kowalchuk head to the box for Arizona State. I got to believe that this is going to end up even here so late in the game. So 1:14 left in the game. In regulation, rather, as I said, 5-minute overtime. If the winner isn't determined then, it becomes a tie for the ACHA. We'll have a shootout to determine a winner or a loser for the WCHL. Referee explaining this to both captains. Oh, and it's just great to see Anthony Cusinelli back out as the captain of the team.
Team Clayton Lackey, 2 minutes for roughing. Sun Devil penalty on number 5, Zach Kowalchuk, 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty, number 25, Trey Decker, 2 minutes for roughing. Wildcat penalty on number 17, Ben Jones, 2 minutes for roughing. All penalties at 18 minutes, 46 seconds of the third period.
The advantage there, Will, for Arizona is that Clayton Lackey, perhaps ASU's best player, is in the penalty box for this last minute 14 of regulation. He's not available out there. That's a huge win for Arizona. Clayton Lackey, such a dangerous player. Face-off in the Arizona zone. Not out of the woods into overtime yet. Still a minute 14 to go in regulation. Won by Arizona State. Arizona's able to get the puck. Here's Chris Westland with the break. Chris Westland with the puck in the break. He takes a shot. Moore makes the save. Chris Westland with a good jump there on the puck. Heading down the wing, but Bronson Moore makes a good save there.
Yeah, it's great to see the crowd getting into it. They haven't had too much to really cheer for today, and in the last five or so minutes, they've been really getting into it. Great rush up there.
This is where I say, and I've said for, I don't know, 33, 34 years now, my tummy hurts. This is when the game is this close against Arizona State, I start sweating profusely and my tummy hurts. This is last minute of play between Arizona and Arizona State. This is rivalry hockey at its best. Arizona and Arizona State in the last minute of regulation. Chris Westland comes away with the puck again. Tries to headman it. He does, but it's poked away. Arizona's going to have to vacate the zone. So that's going to be an offside, I think, on Arizona. Yeah, it is. But Bailey Marshall takes the hit anyway. He took a hit on an Arizona State player. There was nothing dirty about that. He just hit an ASU player. He touched the puck. He had to get out of the zone, so it was a delayed offside there. Let's hope this ASU player is not hurt. There was no intention to hurt this player by Bailey Marshall. Can't quite see who's down right now. By his side is Elliot Plourd. Talking to him. Arizona trainer out to take a look at him, and let's hope he is okay. You know, we love the rivalry. We love the grittiness. Even a little bit of nastiness is okay as long as players don't get hurt. We do not want any of the young men from either of these clubs ever hurt by playing each other in a hockey game. That's just plain silly. We're not interested in that, so... ASU player getting to his feet now. And it looks to be Brendan Studioso. And let's hope Brendan is okay and is able to return. He's getting some help to the bench. Let's hope he is okay. 39 seconds to go in regulation. Now, overtime is 5-on-5. Although, you know, the penalties carry over into overtime. So because... the current penalties will expire about 10 seconds into overtime. We have other penalties on top of that. They're not showing on the board now, so I'm not quite sure how much time is left on them. So we might go 4-on-4 for a few minutes into overtime. ASU now just trying to kill the clock, 25 seconds to go. That's 17 seconds to go. ASU just kind of ragging the puck here. Oh, Bailey Marshall has to be careful there. He reached for the puck. He almost tripped his player. So ASU comes over the line. ASU comes over the line. Last 3 seconds. 2-1. That's it for regulation. We're tied 2-2.
Period. Arizona State with 7. Arizona with 16. For regulation. Arizona State with 26 shots on goal. Arizona with 55 shots on goal.
Oh. Wow. We are going overtime. 55 shots on goal for Arizona. 26 for Arizona State. And ASU has to feel sick. You know, if my tummy hurts, their tummy must really hurt. They had this game in hand. 2-0, had the game completely in control. Now we're heading overtime on the road. The emotion is with Arizona right now. Can they stay out of the box? Can they make the play to beat Bronson Moore one more time? He's been so good in goal for Arizona State. This is for the season series for the Cactus Cup between Arizona and Arizona State. This next goal is huge.
Absolutely. 55 shots on goal for Arizona, and two of those have gone in. Bronson Moore, I know he's let in two in this third period, but 55 shots on goal, and there's only a two up there for Arizona. That's a pretty outstanding play from him. We got some free hockey here, Tim. I'm excited about it, and this has been an excellent, excellent Cactus Cup series here this weekend. Excellent play by both teams, and just excellent games, and you love to see it when it's a rivalry like Arizona and Arizona State.
So remember, if there's no score at the end of regulation for the ACHA rankings for the national record, this will be a tie for both teams. Then we'll have a shootout to determine a winner or a loser for the West Coast Hockey League standings. In the WCHL standings, Arizona has two wins and one loss against Arizona State. In the ACHA standings, they have two wins and one tie against Arizona State. So we'll update those standings in a few minutes here because we're about to head to overtime right now. This is as nail-biting as it can get for an Arizona or Arizona State University fan. There was a game, I'm going to guess 1989 or 90 or something. It was going to go to overtime. It was the last 15 seconds of the game. And Greg Mitchell, one of my favorite players, defenseman for Arizona, comes to the blue line, just throws it towards the ASU net to head back to the bench, and the puck went in the net. And Arizona won with 14 seconds to go. Now, that was the second to last game of the season. So the next night was the big senior announcements. They announced all the players, and no one could hear the announcements because we were all chanting 14 seconds, 14 seconds. For that thrilling victory. It's one of those ASU U of A memories I will never forget. How thrilled that Arizona team was to defeat ASU with just 14 seconds to go. We'll see if there's any kind of similar heroes here tonight for either team. 5 minute overtime. The puck comes out into the slot dangerously. Arizona, Anthony Cusinelli almost had a break with that puck. Now, it's interesting, we're playing 5-on-5, even though there are offsetting penalties to start this overtime. I'm not quite sure why. There were still penalties, and we still have penalties on the boards, offsetting penalties in the box. So there must be a different set of circumstances for overtime with guys in the box. 4 minutes now to go in overtime if the puck comes out in front. No Arizona players there, though, and we have a whistle and a hand pass on Arizona State. So we'll have a face-off in the ASU zone. Under 4 minutes to go in overtime. Boy, Arizona doubling up on the shots on ASU, 55-26 in regulation. But the only numbers that count are the ones on the scoreboard. 2-2.
And two games, Tim, yesterday and today, that ASU absolutely could have won. And it would be just a gut punch if Arizona can come back and win this game, and then ASU's going back to Tempe feeling like we could have won both of those games.
No, that's absolutely right. I think emotionally, and I think one of the teams has ASU has called their timeout here with the 3:58 to go in overtime. Emotionally, I think it would be a crippling thing for this ASU team. They have played so well, and like you said, they could have won last night. They can win here tonight, but if they don't, you got to hope, you know, win or lose, that this is a wake-up call for Arizona.
Yeah.
This has got to be a wake-up call to the Arizona Wildcats. They're the ones on home ice here. These are two league games against your rival, and they can't feel, you know, if they lose this game, they can't feel good about, well, we came back and tied the game and turned it in overtime. Unless, of course, they can get to the shootout and they got a tie out of it, then it's kind of a victory because they should have lost this game already. If they survive the five-minute overtime without scoring, or no one scoring, and it becomes an ACHA tie, and that helps for the Cactus Cup because then suddenly they'd have two wins and two ties. And ASU, those ties are as good as losses for ASU with Arizona with a two-victory lead. So. More hockey to go until we can talk about that stuff. 3:50 to go in overtime. And now we're skating 3-on-3. So, again, I'm not quite sure. As ASU comes right in, they shoot the winning goal in overtime. Brendan Studioso with the goal. I'm not quite sure what just happened there. Why were we skating 3-on-3 suddenly after skating 5-on-5? But ASU comes away with the victory in overtime.
And much deserved. They were the better team tonight, and it is a deserved win there for Arizona State.
Yeah, a deserved victory for Arizona State. They get the OT game winner. So now it's 2 wins for Arizona, 1 win for Arizona State, and a tie. So the race for the Cactus Cup is on. A great victory by Arizona State. Now stick around because we'll talk, we'll have a post-game interview at Center Ice and then our post-game report here from the press box. The final score, Arizona State 3, Arizona 2 in overtime. Stick around, we'll have our post-game report coming up. Well-deserved victory for the Arizona State University Sun Devils. Arizona lucky to push this one to overtime. And, of course, ASU will be here to end the semester in just about a month. Those games are going to be crazy. So let's go down now to Center Ice for our post-game interviews, and then stick around. We'll have our post-game report here from the press box.
Hi, I'm Jackson Peters, and I'm joined with head coach of the University of Arizona Wildcats, Coach Chad Berman. Now, Coach, of course not the outcome you expected, but you guys were able to put on a lot of shots tonight, outshooting them 2-1. What do you think the deciding factor was here tonight?
To be honest with you, I liked our game better tonight than last night. I thought we were much cleaner. I thought we played a pretty good competitive 60. You know, we had a couple opportunities early we just didn't capitalize on, and at the same time, you got to give their goalie credit. I thought he played really well.
Yeah, you definitely faced a hot goaltender tonight, but last night you talked a little bit about how your guys in the defensive zone were a little bit confused and you wanted them to play a little bit more on their toes. Did you see a little bit more of that tonight?
Yeah, as a coach, you want to teach process. It can't always be about the outcome, because if you stick to the process, good things will happen. I liked our game better today. I thought our PK adjustments were really good. I thought we played better. We just didn't do enough.
And before I let you go, Coach, is there anything you'd like to say to the fans here tonight?
Great crowd. Thanks for coming out. We got a good team. Big things ahead. Hope to see you at more games. Thank you.
Thanks, Coach. Well, we spoke with head coach Chad Berman. If you're joining us on our YouTube or Facebook broadcast, I'll send it back to the booth with Tim Gaston and Will Harmon. If you're joining us in-house, I hope you'll join us next Thursday at 7:30 or Friday and Saturday at 1 p.m. as the University of Arizona Wildcats play here again. Thanks so much for coming out, and have a good night.
Thank you, Jackson. Another great college hockey game here from the Tucson Arena. Number 10 Arizona State defeats Arizona by a score of 3-2 in overtime. This was a great college hockey game. And, you know, after how ASU played last night and tonight, they deserve to win this game.
Yeah, I think they were the better team tonight, and deservedly so. They came out with the win. It would have been nice, obviously, if Arizona came back and was able to almost steal a game. But Arizona State did play really well, and Bronson Moore was unbelievable in net. 55 shots on goal is out of control, and that's just a great performance from him all around.
Yeah, Arizona doubling up at the shots on Arizona State, but as we said, the only number that really matters is the scoreboard number, and Arizona State comes up with that big goal in overtime to defeat the Arizona Wildcats. So they improve to 9-4-1 on the season. Arizona drops to 9-2-1, but you know, this was a WCHL game, and that's even more important perhaps than the Cactus Cup, because both ASU and U of A in the WCHL. This puts ASU right in that race for the leaders board with Arizona in the league.
Yeah, and that's kind of what you're going for if you're ASU. You usually try and go for a split when you're on the road at the very least. They were able to pick that up today. And especially for an Arizona State team that is much improved, you know, going back, if you're going back to Tempe 0-2 in games that you feel like you could have won one, that's not necessarily a great feeling, obviously, and especially in games where you feel like you could have won the game. For them to be able to pull off the split, that's huge, and a huge thing for this rivalry in the Cactus Cup moving forward.
Well, and we're only halfway through the season against Arizona State. Four more games against Arizona State, all here at the Tucson Arena. The next two will finish out the first semester of play, and you know that's going to be a war here in Tucson. The final two against ASU will be the last games of the year here in February at the Tucson Arena, and I get the feeling a WCHL crown or a top 10 kind of ranking could be at stake by the time ASU comes back to town.
Yeah, this is a great series from them, from both the squads. And you know, we heard about how improved Arizona State was, and we really saw it this weekend, and especially for how good. And this is not taking credit away from the Wildcats. See, the Wildcats are a very strong team as well. It just makes the rivalry that much better when both teams have the quality that they do, and we saw last night and tonight. I mean, these guys are really going to be bringing it throughout the season. I'm excited to see where both these teams kind of end up too later on at the end of the season. They're going to be probably completely different teams than the ones we saw, but they already are both really strong teams right now as well.
Well, this is just the start of a long homestand for the Arizona Wildcats here at the Tucson Arena. We'll play four out of the next five weekends, just taking off Thanksgiving weekend, and we'll be right back at it here at the Tucson Arena this Thursday. Arizona Hockey will drop the puck at 7:30. Our broadcast will start at 7:15 p.m. Tonight. So thanks to everyone who joined us here for this exciting game. We hope you'll come to the Tucson Arena or join our broadcast on Thursday night. For Will Harmon and Jackson Peters, I'm Timothy Gasson. Thank you for our entire Arizona Hockey media crew. You have been watching University of Arizona Wildcat Hockey.
Thank you for watching University of Arizona Wildcats Hockey. Visit our website at arizonawildcathockey.org, and we'll see you at the Tucson Arena for the next Arizona Wildcats home game.